Good afternoon and welcome to Stillwell Stadium, home of your 2022 Kennesaw State Baseball team. And today, the NCAA Conference matchup between Stetson University Hatters and the Kennesaw State Owls. The NCAA Conference and Kennesaw State University encourage and promote good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Thank you for your cooperation. We hope you enjoy today's game. Jimmy Johns is proud to support Kennesaw State University. Jimmy Johns is freaky fast, so your sandwich arrives freaky fresh. Order today at jimmyjohns.com or visit your local Kennesaw Jimmy Johns after the game. Atlanta Air Charter has been safely operating the fleet for over 15 years. Atlanta Air Charter's passion for aviation has led them to form the Atlanta Air Academy to train, mentor, and provide a pathway to prepare well-trained pilots. For more information on the Atlanta Air Academy, please visit www.atlantaairacademy.com. They're also available by phone 24/7. Atlanta Air Charter is a proud supporter of Kennesaw State Athletics and is waiting for your call. USA Rugby 7 Collegiate Championship is coming to Fifth Third Bank Stadium this weekend, May 14th and 15th. Come see the best players from over 50 colleges compete here at KSU. Fast-paced action, all-day fan festival, beer garden, and more. Visit r7cc.rugby for exclusive ticket options. the starting lineups. First for the visitors for the Stetson University Hatters. Leading off in playing center field is number two, Cameron Hill. Batting second and playing right field is number three, Camden Traficante. Batting third and playing left field, number 11, Nick DiPanzio. Batting fourth and playing first base, number 23, Jacob Bullard. Batting fifth, designated hitter, number 24, Juan Correa.
A Sun Conference baseball series begins on Friday the 13th. Welcome to Stillwell Stadium. Nolan Alexander joined by Trey Fowler as Kennesaw State is set to host Stetson, the first of a three-game series here with a 5 p.m. first pitch. Trey, Kennesaw State is coming off a come-from-behind win against Western Carolina in the midweek game on Wednesday, a game that we call good effort for KSU. Capitalized with that Cash Young three-run homer.
Cash Young was money for the Owls on Wednesday. He has been all year long. They will need him to continue that as they close out the regular season, these last seven games, especially here this weekend against visiting Hatters.
Kennesaw State comes into this ball game today with a 15-9 record in the A-Sun, 28-21 overall. Stetson is 22-26, sitting at 7-17 in the A-Sun. Trey, these teams have already met a part of the A-Sun scheduling. Kennesaw State went down to Melching Field and DeLand earlier this year and swept the Hatters thanks to stellar pitching, gave up just four earned runs. They look to duplicate that this weekend.
They're really looking to take advantage of a Hatter offense that struggled this year. They've struggled to maintain health. They've struggled to perform offensively. The Owls are hoping that those trends continue this weekend, that they can do exactly what they did down in DeLand with where their RPI sits. They can't afford many more losses down the stretch if they want to remain in contention for an at-large bid to the tournament.
We'll step aside for the national anthem and come back with First Pitch Stetson and Kennesaw State on the KSU Owl Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join Kennesaw State University and our players and coaches in honoring America and celebrating its freedom and those who protect it. Let us rise as one nation and one people for the play of our national anthem.
Here we go, Stetson and Kennesaw State to begin a three-game series from a sunny Stillwell Stadium on a Friday afternoon, 79 degrees. Just a few bit of clouds well beyond the outfield and not much of a breeze at all to speak of. No wind today. Let's take a look at this Stetson Hatter lineup. Stetson 22-26 in the year, 7-17 in the A-Sun Conference. Leading off and playing center field, it's number two, Cameron Hill. Batting second for the Hatters, playing right field, it's number three, Camden Traficante. Batting third and playing left field, number 11, Nick DiPanzio. Hitting cleanup and playing first base, Jacob Bullard, number 23. Batting fifth and DHing today, Juan Correa, number 24, Correa. In the sixth hole for the Hatters, at the hot corner, the third baseman, number 13, Kyle Ball. Batting seventh and playing second base, it's number 38, Johan Desuro. batting eighth for the Hatters and catching. One of the top defensive catchers, not only the A-Sum, but the entire nation, number 34, Christian Pregent. Christian Pregent catching. And batting ninth for the Hatters, the shortstop, number 50, Andrew Estrella. And on the mound that we'll see in the home half of the first, Nick Durgan for the Hatters. Defensively for Kennesaw State, here's how Ryan Coe uses his lineup. In the outfield from left to right, it's Zach Corbin, Josh Hatcher, and Braden Eadson. In the infield, the usual suspects, Cash Young at third base, Tyler Simon, the captain, at short. Hudson Mims takes second base. Donovan Cash, he is red hot offensively at first base today. And Nick Hassan, the battery mate for Jack Myers on the bump today for the Owls. The righty senior is 4-3 with a 3.41 ERA, making start number 13 of the year here on Friday the 13th. He's pitched 66 innings, given up 61 hits, 25 earned runs. He has struck out 50 and walked 20 with a 2.38 opponent's average. And going against Stetson for the second time this season. The righty begins the windup in the first pitch of the ball game. Is up and away to Cameron Hill. 1-0 the count here at 5:01 from Stillwell Stadium. Hill settling in here, a 3.21 batter making his 49th start of the year, 1-0 pitch. And he takes one above the knees down the middle, 1-1 the count.
Yeah, Owl staff and Myers would both like to see him repeat last time out against the Hatters. 7 innings, 5 hits, only 1 earned run.
His 1-1 is high as Hill lays off, 2 balls and a strike.
That was en route to 11-1 victory in the Friday night game down in DeLand.
2-1 pitch. Upstairs above the hands, 3 balls and a strike to Cameron Hill. Hill with 9 extra base hits that have been doubles, 5 triples, 2 home runs, and 24 driven in. He's walked 21 times on the year. The 424 on-base percentage. Hitters count at 3-1. He swings and pops it up behind the dish. Hassan gives it a look, but it's bound for beyond the bleachers here in the press box. And the count runs full to the leadoff batter, Cameron Hill.
Very important for Myers to get Hill here. He sits third in the A-Sun in stolen bases with 22.
Righty on lefty, the payoff pitch. Swing and a pop-up sprayed foul out of play left field side.
The Hatters actually have 2 of the top 3 stolen base threats in the conference, with both Hill and DiPonzio hitting 1-3 in the order.
So Myers, the first year out, tries it again with a 3-2, and that's outside. A leadoff walk to Cameron Hill. 21st walk issued by Myers, and the 22nd walk taken by Hill.
The Hatters rank 11th in hits and runs, 12th in average in the A-Sun. And for an offense that's having the struggles the Hatters have, it's very important that the Owls this weekend do not give them free base runners and make their ability to score runs that much easier.
It's the right fielder, Camden Traficante, who's reached base in 8 straight games for Stetson. Another lefty batter here as the righty Myers moves into the stretch and misses down and in over the shoe tops. A 1-0 count here, runner on first. It's Hill being held on by Donovan Cash. No score, top of the first. Al middle infield to double play depth. Simon the shortstop and Mims at second base. Myers sets from just outside the belt. A nod with the black cap and the 1-0 pitch. Runs away, 2 balls and no strikes. Traficante hitting a little under 300. The sophomore is at 293. This is at bat number 100 of the season. He has 29 hits with 3 doubles and 9 driven in. Myers with the sign, looking for a strike here, down 2-0. But first, a checkup over at first, and no tag applied by Cash.
Traficante, the switch hitter, hits slightly better from the right side, 304 as opposed to the 292 left-handed.
Myers kicks 2-0. Fastball just misses down and away. Hassan out of the crouch, intending a possible steal attempt from Hill, who remains at bay. And Myers again tries to find the zone here, down 3-0 to the two-hole hitter, Traficante. The pitch. And a fastball granted on the inner half, 3-1. Stetson wearing the road grays today with Stetson across the front in green. Numbers on the left belly. Green numbers with a lighter green trim on the back. Gray pants, thin green line down the sides, and green caps for the Hatters. A nod in the 3-1 from Jack Myers. Misses down and in, and back-to-back walks for Stetson to start out the ballgame.
Definitely not the way you want to start if you're the Owls. As I said before, you're giving the offensive deficient at many times this year, Stetson Hatters, a chance to score runs without getting base hits. You got a speedy runner in the box. Wouldn't be surprised to see him try and lay one down, move these runners into scoring position.
You mentioned the speed of Hill at second base with 22 swipes. Nick DiPonzio here, another lefty batter. 23 for 29 in stolen bases on the year. Two on, no outs. He does square to bunt and sends it up the first baseline. Barehanded by the catcher, Hassan, who zips to first. And a nice sacrifice bunt from the Stetson left fielder. Moves two in scoring position, now one away for Jacob Buller, the cleanup hitter and the first baseman for Stetson.
Now, myself personally, Nolan, as a coach, I never liked giving a guy who had walked the first two hitters his first out, but I think this is more Jack Myers' history playing into that. He's not a guy that typically walks a bunch, so they're looking to take advantage and score on him early.
Bullard, a sophomore, makes his 42nd start of the year, and he looks at a slider that grips the lower and outer half, 0-1. No score here, top of the first. Stetson has Cameron Hill at third base and Camden Traficante at second.
Bullard has struck out 46 times on the year. Myers would love to make it number 47.
Ahead in the count and the 0-1 from the righty. Swinging a high chopper back at the middle. Hudson Mims at second takes it. Only play is to first base. It's on the right field side of the bag. Donovan Cash with a bit of a shift. And it's a ground out for Bullard, an RBI one at that, that plates Cameron Hill, and Stetson goes on top 1-0 here in the first.
That'll be the first time that the Hatters have scored first so far this year against the Owls.
Bullard picks up his 24th RBI. Correa, the DH out of the five hole, swings the first pitch, nubs it in front of the mound. It's fielded. Myers falls to the backside, throws to first in time, though. And that puts an end to the inning on the 1-3 ground down. That could have been dangerous for the Owls, but Myers shows nice composure from his fanny, throwing out Correa. Stetson goes on top, though, without a base knock. One run, no hits, no errors, and a runner stranded. Bottom half of the first, Josh Hatcher to lead it off for the Owls with the score Stetson 1, Kennesaw State nothing. This is the KSU Owl Network. Back at Stillwell Stadium for the home half of the first inning. Stetson with a 1-0 lead against Kennesaw State. As the Hatters look to improve upon their 7-17 record in the A-Sun, Kennesaw State trying to jockey for first place in the East Division at 15-9. Here's a look at the Kennesaw State starting lineup today. Led off by this man, Josh Hatcher in center field. Tyler Simon takes short. Zach Corbin in left field. Donovan Cash bats cleanup at first. Cash Young in the five hole at third. Spencer Hansen DHs and bats sixth. Hudson Mims in the seven hole at second. And the pitch from Durgin misses, a swing and a foul back to the backstop, 0-1. Nick Hassan bats eighth and catches for the Owls. And Braden Edson in right field hits nine. This pitch is grounded directly to first. A nice stop by a bowler between the legs, and he wins the foot race to first base and the three unassisted. One away in the KSU first.
So we saw something there that we haven't seen very often lately, a starting pitcher starting Josh Hatcher with a first pitch fastball, but it was located well. All he could do was foul it back to the screen. Durgan gets the ground out.
So one out, 1-0 Stetson. Tyler Simon up and swings and sends a liner back into center field. And so the Owls capture the first base hit of the afternoon.
Durgan, just like Myers, had a quality start in his outing against the Owls down in DeLand. He threw the Saturday game that time around, 7 innings, 7 hits, 2 runs, only 1 earned, 1 walk, 4 strikeouts, and received the no decision in game 2.
Had some tough luck this year. He's 1-4, but has a 4.04 ERA. Makes start number 10 today. Into the stretch for the righty, and the switch hitter, Zach Corbin, dribbles it foul back behind the backstop. 0-1 here. Might have caught a little bit of the catcher, Pregent, as the home plate umpire, Lee Ishman, escorts the baseball back to the front of the mound for Durgan. Creel Waddell at first base, and Matthew Wilbanks, the third base umpire today, who's now positioned on the right side of second base. Corbin hitting .325 this year, 52 for 160 with 7 doubles, a triple, and 3 home runs. The pitch, swing and a ground ball shot through the right side. Into right field, Traficante picks it up. Simon holds at second base, and the Owls have back-to-back singles here in the first.
Simon and Corbin setting the table for the Owls' hottest hitter. 5 multi-hit games in a row as he steps to the plate here. Donovan Cash against Durgan.
Donovan Cash with a 4-hit game. And the Wednesday win against Western Carolina. 1-0, Kennesaw State trails Stetson here in the first. A 5-game hitting streak currently for Cash and a 17-game reach base streak. A righty-on-righty matchup. The pitch. Swing and a pop-up first base side. Bowler, the first baseman, jogs over and runs out of real estate 0-1. Cash is hitting .364 with 68 hits on the year. 16 doubles for the Owls, second on the squad behind Hatcher's 21. 4 home runs and 42 driven in. Durden from the belt. And his fastball's downstairs, 1-1.
Durgan was a guy who appeared to be set for greatness in a Hatter uniform, had a great freshman year, sustained an injury last year that took him out towards the end of the season, and has not quite regained his full form back yet.
Sticks in the board. The pitch is a breaking ball cut on and shot foul to the Owls' third base dugout. 1-2 on Donovan Cash.
Durgan trying to follow in a long line of Stetson Hatter pitchers that have went on to do big-time things.
Yeah, take your pick of Hatter's pitchers that have gone on to the bigs. 1-2 is a breaking ball down and away. 2-2 on Cash.
One of their latest knocking on the door is Brooks Wilson. Obviously trying to join former staff mate Logan Gilbert up in the big leagues, as Wilson is at AAA with the Braves here in Atlanta.
2-1, 1-out. The 2-2 pitch. Swing and a line drive. Shot into left field. That's in for a base knock and bounces up against the wall. Simon coasts around third base, and the throw from left into DiPonzio comes into third. Donovan Cash, have yourself a month of May. His 17th double of the season, 43rd RBI, and we're tied at 1.
We spoke about it early in the year. Donovan Cash is a guy that We had a hard time as a coaching staff last year redshirting because we knew the potential that he had to bring so much. That potential is showing up this year in 2022 for Ryan Coe and the new staff.
Back to the windup here, and Cash Young shoots it into left field. An RBI knock for Young. Donovan Cash around third, and he is in without a throw. A two-run single off the bat of Cash Young. Back-to-back RBI knocks, and the Owls lead 3-1.
I can't tell you how deflating this is, Nolan, for the Hatters, a team that struggles to score runs. Gets on the board early, takes a lead in the top of the first inning, only to see the Owls storm back with at least three here in the bottom half and still looking for more.
Four consecutive hits, and that's RBIs 51 and 52 for Young. Spencer Hansen looks at a fastball in the dirt, 1-0. Hansen has hit in five straight for Kennesaw State, trying to get the average to 300. He's at 289 with 33 hits in the year, seven doubles, a couple homers, and 28 driven in, stretching the pitch. And the fastball is aligned with the outer half, 1-1.
And Spencer Hansen's another guy that's been swinging the bat hot lately. Had a big weekend last weekend against Florida Gulf Coast. Looks to continue that here versus the Hatters.
1-1 pitch, down and in. Two balls and a strike to Hansen. 3-1 Kennesaw State leads. Josh Hatcher began the inning with a ground out to Bullard at first. Since then, Simon, Corbin, Cash, and Young have all hit. Three singles and a Cash double. 2-1. Check swing on a breaking ball, diving low and outside. Hansen able to lay off. Three balls, one strike. Durgan with a peek over at first base. And now the pitch. Swing and a chopper out to short. Estrella Field slings over to second. The relay to first by Desereau is in time with a nice stretch by Bullard. So Stetson ends the inning with a 6-4-3 double play. But the Owls are able to answer and take the lead with three runs off of four base hits, no errors, and none left on. One in the books, 3-1 Kennesaw State leads. You're tuned in to the KSU Owl Network. Welcome back to the second inning from Stillwell Stadium. Kennesaw State and Stetson in the first of three. Sees the Owls with a 3-1 lead. Nolan Alexander joined by Trey Fowler. Stetson got on the board first without a base hit thanks to a couple leadoff walks to Cameron Hill and Camden Traficante. So Stetson has the 6, 7, and 8 batters for Steve Trimper's squad. And the third baseman, Kyle Ball, running a 5-game reach base streak. Set to lead it off from the right side. The righty Jack Myers delivers and connects above the knees, 0-1. Ball stands in, hitting .264 with 37 knocks on the year. Three doubles, a triple, one home run, 16 driven in. The pitch. Granted in the upper and outer half of the zone, and Myers back to his usual self with a no-ball, two-strike count.
Ball owns the distinction of being Trimper's first recruit to Stetson when he took the job from Maine. He was actually committed to Maine and came to Stetson with Trimper.
0-2, breaking ball in the dirt in the opposite batter's box, 1-2. Trimper came in for the legendary Pete Dunne. As you said, coming from Maine, led the Bears to somewhat of a regular in the NCAA tournament, made some noise as well. 1-2 pitch. Breaking ball wasted low and away. Two balls and two strikes. Got to Stetson. Had great success early on. The Hatters reaching the Super Regional round. And has run into some tough luck this year. A bevy of injuries have limited the Hatters' performance. 2-2. Fastball misses inside, and the counts fold the leadoff batter of the second inning. Kyle Ball out of the six hole. KSU with a 3-1 lead. Kennesaw State led by Ryan Coe. Mike Trimper. Coe coming in to replace a legend in Mike Sansing. Payoff pitch. A breaking ball grounded softly to third. Cash Young waits on it. Collects, pats the glove, throws a bit high over to first, but beats out Ball by a couple of steps. 5-3 and one away. Coe and the Owls sitting 15-9 in the A-Sun, trying to chase the KSU record for A-Sun wins in a season. Got out to the best start in Division I at 7-1. Rode some struggles with a long road swing. Got out to a very hot start in the conference. And trying to pick up a series win here. The pitch misses outside. 1-0 to the seven-hole hitter, Johan Desereau. The freshman's hitting 267. Canadian with 36 hits in the year, 21 driven in. The pitch is cut on and missed. And a 1-1 count in a righty versus lefty matchup.
You mentioned that team that Trimper inherited that went to the Super Regionals.
1-1. Fastball below the hands, too far inside, two balls and a strike.
A team largely constructed by former head coach Pete Dunn and his recruiting coordinator at the time, Mark Levitt.
The offering. Swing and a miss. Takes him outside. Foul tip to the mid of Hassan. Count levels at 2.
Levitt, one of the great men in college baseball at the time. Really, really genuinely nice dude. And
Roddy deals. Swing and a miss. Myers pulls the string, collects his first K, and there's two outs in the Stetson second.
And I'm sure he was happy to see all the success they had in that trip to not only making a Super Regional where they lost to North Carolina, but hosting a regional, mm-hmm. which you don't see very often from mid-major teams.
Christian Pregent, known for his defensive efforts, offense not as much, hitting 206 this year, does have four home runs, and he's driven in 17. First pitch from Myers, a check swing to the outer half. Appeal over to first, Waddell says no go. And a 1-0 count. Myers quickly to the dish. Swing and a miss on a breaking ball across the zone. 1-1. Owls leading this one 3-1. Second inning. Bases empty. Two outs and the eight-hole hitter. The Stetson catcher up at the dish from the right side. The delivery. A breaking ball good on the inner half. 1-2.
And Pregent is somewhat of an anomaly in college baseball. Named team captain as a freshman. Do not see that happen very often, if at all.
1-2 pitch. Lays off a pitch with a late bite outside, 2-2. Yes, I'm sure that is a very small list of players that can sport that accolade. Deuce is wild here, the 2-2. Swing and a number pulled foul to the Owls dugout.
Regarded by many as one of the top defensive catchers in the entire country. So far this year, no errors on the year in 277 chances. Last year, only a single error in 345 chances.
Another 2-2. Breaking ball plunks him on the front left shoulder. And it's a two-out base runner for Stetson in the bottom of the order. And with limited depth at catcher, he has been an everyday warrior for the Hatters. He'll have to likely finish out the season with that same task as well.
Daniel Labrador, their backup catcher, who was swinging the bat well, probably out for the remainder of the year. But that's nothing new to Stetson Hatter fans. Austin Hill caught a large majority of every game. He was there for Stetson over 4 years as well.
Andrew Estrade, the shortstop, up and chops it over to third in a funny hop underneath the glove of an incoming Cash Young. It finds its way into left field as Corbin picks it up, and the Hatters have gone from their last strike of the second inning with two up, two down, and now have runners at first and second.
Not the time that you want to make mistakes and give free base runners to set it up for their best hitter and most dangerous threat at the plate in Cameron Hill. These are the things that the Owls have to avoid to do what they want to do this weekend.
Cameron Hill walked on a full count in the first inning. That goes down as an E5. So two on, two outs. Owls up by two in the second. And the pitch misses down and in. A slight bend at the waist by Hill, but does not move the stick towards it, 1-0.
That last play right there, Cash Young caught in between. He started back and then tried to break in. If he comes in right away, probably gets that ball in the short hop.
1-0 from the righty. Swing and a liner and a diving grab by Cash Young to his left. Leans outside the left knee and snares it. And the inning comes to a close. Stetson again with a couple of base runners. This time the Hatters do not score. No runs, no hits, one error, two stranded. On to the home half of the second with a 7-8-9 men due up for the Owls. And the score, Kennesaw State 3 and Stetson 1 on the KSU Owl Network. Bottom two at the Shake, KSU 3 and Stetson 1. Hudson Mims, the freshman second baseman, leads it off for the Owls. After him, we'll see Nick Hassan on deck, Braden Edson in the hole. Mims, a 259 batter, makes start number 46 today. Two home runs, 19 driven in. Righty on righty, and the pitch connects down the pipe, 0-1. Kennesaw State had four consecutive hits in the last inning. Scores three runs. 0-1 pitch to Mims. Grabs the outer half. 0-2.
And his struggles this week continue of facing some tough pitcher's pitches.
0-2 from the righty. Durgan comes in and hits Mims on the hands. Appeal over to first base. And Mims able to shake it off. Twists off the batting gloves and the protection, and now Archie, the trainer, out of the third base dugout, trots to follow him up the first baseline. That hit him and then ricocheted up against the net, an appeal to first to see if it was foul. And it's off Mims. Again, Archie attending to him along with Bo Way, the first base coach.
And Mims is a tough kid, tough freshman, and Archie had to work extra hard to run out there and catch up to him, as he was wasting no time getting down to first base. The appeal down there was, in fact, to see if he swung, which would have been a dead ball and strike three had he swung. So he finds his way on base for the third time this week, despite facing a lot of tough pitcher's pitches. Had a couple strikeouts on Wednesday, but getting the Owls going here with the hit-by-pitch.
Mims remains in the ballgame. And here's the catcher, Nick Hassan. Hitting 226, 31 for 137, with seven doubles and 18 driven in. And as you noted in our call on Wednesday, Trey, his contact has improved. Stretching the pitch, he's showing bunt here, pops it up third base side. It's a good one. Scooped up at third by Ball, and he has nowhere to go. Nick Hassan, the catcher, bunts for a single.
Shades of former catcher Max Pentecost with the bunt base hit right there. Tyler Tolvey also really good at that for the Owls. And that is how you snap out of slumps. Hits like that. Nick Hassan starting to heat up. And the rest of the A-Sun better watch out, because if this bat gets going along with the other ones that are already in this Owls lineup, this offense will be even more productive than they already are, sitting second in the league in offense.
So Durgan puts two on here. 3-1 Kennesaw State leads. Braden Edson, the lefty up out of the nine hole. He's showing bunt and dribbles another good one. Left side of the mound. Pitcher plucks, has no throw. Back-to-back bunt singles for Kennesaw State.
And those two right there get me excited. There's nothing more than I like to see a bunt base hit. And the Strong Rock boys go back-to-back. Not the way you would expect, not back-to-back dingers, back-to-back bunts, base hits, and they set the table for the man who loves to hit with the bases loaded, Josh Atcher.
A grand slam at Melching Field in game one earlier this year against the Hatters. Back to the wine, the pitch, a breaking ball. He was swinging there, pops it up, foul ground, third base side, but out of play. 0-1 to Hatcher, who's 0-1 today with the ground out to first. Kennesaw State leads 3-1, batting in the second inning, bases juiced and no outs.
Josh Hatcher, three grand slams already on the year, looking to make it number four.
Righty on lefty, the pitch, swinging a liner into right field. Not a grand slam, but an RBI hit. One run comes home to score. That's Hudson Mims. 4-1 Kennesaw State on Josh Hatcher's 38th RBI of the season.
Good job right there getting the second breaking ball up in the zone, not missing it, and doing a lot of damage. On the call yesterday with the Stetson SID, he mentioned how Nick Durgin's breaking ball might not have the same bite it had prior to the injury, and we're seeing that today, staying up in the zone a little bit.
Tyler Simon winding the pitch, looks at a fastball at the knees in the outer half, 0-1.
One thing he will not be short of is competitiveness, and that is one thing that makes him one of the best pitchers in the conference.
Kicks and fires, swing and a fly ball, sent out to left field. DiPonzio going back at the wall. DiPonzio jumps, and he's unable to grab it. He's down on the ground. It's the shortstop Estrella running out for it, and they're going to wave it a home run. It's called a home run. Tyler Simon with a grand slam, and DiPonzio is down in left field.
That's one of the first times we have seen a guy hit that part of the wall. That's right there at the window where it juts out a little bit. We obviously hope that DiPonzio will be okay, a tremendous player for the Hatters and a tremendous player within this league. But he hit a part of that wall that has absolutely no give to it. Credit him for not giving up on that ball and going hard the whole way.
Silence upon us here at Stillwell Stadium, something you would never see after a grand slam. But both training staff, Steve Tremper, the coach, and the outfielders, and Estrella all out to attend to the Stetson left fielder Nick DiPonzio. As you said, all-out effort against the window casing out in left field.
And if you notice that area right there out where he hit in front of that window, the ball has to hit above that window there to be a home run. It actually has to hit the fascia of the Bailey building there. Everywhere else around above that yellow line is a home run. There is unfortunately no yellow line out there where that window is. The umpires ruled that it hit above that window and was in fact a home run.
And DiPonzio is up with the help of the training staff.
And they will take him right inside there. The training room lies just beyond that door, so the Stetson trainer and trainer for Kennesaw State, Chris Archambeau, will get DiPonzio inside and make sure he gets looked at.
So our prayers and thoughts here with DiPonzio being attended to in left field, and if we hear anything more on an update from him, we'll be sure to let you know. Meanwhile, Stetson has brought in a new left fielder, and now the umpires get together.
And that's going to be Connor Keel, the new left fielder for Stetson. The umpires are probably talking here and trying to discuss whether that ball did in fact hit off the building or off the window. Two distinctly different sounds, and that's really the only way you can tell is by the sound. Sometimes it's hard to tell exactly where it hit. Now, I think the result of the play may have ended up being the same thing,
yes,
no matter what, since DiPanzio was unable to get back to his feet. They will stick with the home run call.
So Tyler Simon hits a grand slam for Kennesaw State. His second hit of the day, and it's 8-1 Owls here in the second inning. It's the fourth home run of the season for Simon, and now 33 RBI for the fifth-year captain. And Trimper out for a conversation with Lee Ishman, the home plate umpire. And that is one thing that always happens before game one of a series, Trey. Both head coaches get together, Ryan Coe for Kennesaw State, Trimper for Stetson. And game one start usually a little longer because the coaches go over the ground rules with the umpiring crew.
And that is a unique rule here. It was that way when I first got here as a coach back in 2013. We actually put up a temporary fence. We actually jokingly called that the Max Pentecost wall there for a little while in 2014, and then the new wall came back, and when it did, we put the building back in play. The old rule stated that the ball had to go up and stay on the building for it to be a home run. So you would see left fielders field balls off the wall and throw guys out at second base. Probably the best to ever do it, Jake Bruce, who used to play left field here for the Owls, had a lot of assists that way, fielding the ball off the wall and firing to second.
Zach Corbin up, and Corbin looks away. Bases are empty now. No outs in the second inning. Five across for the Owls, and an 8-1 lead for Kennesaw State against Stetson. Righty on lefty, and the switch hitter Corbin takes up and away. So the new left fielder replacing the injured Nick DiPanzio is Connor Keel, a redshirt senior, 5'11", 185, out of Eden Prairie, Minnesota, and transfer from Chippewa Community College. Kick and the delivery, swing and a miss by Corbin, missed on the heater.
Chippewa, obviously a perennial power in junior college year after year. They actually dropped a game yesterday to College of Central Florida, so we'll have to fight out of the loser's bracket.
Swing and a miss on the 2-1, and the count evens at 2. There is some action in the Hatter bullpen up the right field line. Kick the 2-2. Swing and a pop-up, foul ground, Kyle Ball, the third baseman, running to the edge of the Owls' dugout, and he watches it land as a Stillwell souvenir. Corbin steps out momentarily, then crawls back into the left side, back left foot first, then the front right. We'll see another 2-2 from the righty. And Georgian misses away, and the count's full at 3-2.
The Hatters have a lefty in the pen. That's going to be Anthony DeFabia warming up.
3-2 is nubbed towards third. Ball running in, scoops at third, throws on the run, and bullets the throw over to first. A nice defensive play by the Hatter hot corner, Kyle Ball. And that's just the first out of the second inning.
Really good play right there. That ball came off the end of the bat. It's going to be spinning awkwardly. Might have a gash in it. He's able to make a nice play for out number one.
Donovan Cash doubled earlier. The delivery, and that misses at the letters, 1-0. Cash, as we noted, hit his 17th double of the season. 1-0 pitch, swing and a fly ball out of play to right field. One ball and one strike, tying for yet another multi-hit game. He had his first four-hit game in the win over Western Carolina Wednesday. He leads the Owls with 23 multi-hit games. 1-1 to Donovan Cash outside, 2-1. What an inning it's been for Kennesaw State. Five across, 2-1 pitch. Swing and a fly ball that is delivered deep out to left center field, and Donovan Cash sees it roll all the way up against the base of the wall. And he's got, no, it's ruled a home run. Home run for Donovan Cash. It's ruled a home run later by the third base umpire. Donovan Cash leaves the building. Second home run for the Owls this inning.
That's a great job by third base umpire Matthew Wilbanks getting out there to see that that ball did, in fact, hit outside the park off the steps and then back in the steps that run alongside of that Bailey building. And a great job of hustling out there and seeing that one and being able to catch an eye on that. Donovan Cash stays red hot and tries to continue staking his claim to A-Sun Freshman of the Year accolades. He is moving ever so close to that award as he continues to put these multi-hit games together.
Donovan Cash with his fifth home run of the season. Delivers the blast out to left center. We'll have a new Hatter pitcher. Kennesaw State opens up the offense here in the second inning. We'll pause for the new Hatter pitcher. The score, Kennesaw State 9 and Stetson 1. This is the KSU Owl Network. Anthony DeFabia brought in out of the Stetson bullpen against Cash Young, and the pitch is good at the knees for a strike, 0-1. Kennesaw State with a monster inning here, 6 across, 9-1 Owls. DeFabia trying to clean up the mess and misses outside, a ball and a strike here to Cash Young, who singled back in the first inning. Working quickly, the southpaw delivers and misses down and away. Two balls and one strike. DeFabia, 5'11", 185 out of Bronxville, New York, and Iona Prep. And delivers again, but misses inside near the belt. Three balls and one strike. Quickly with the sign. And the pitch is cut on and missed as it runs down and in. The count's full here at 3-2. DeFabia, 0-2 with an 8.76 ERA on the year. Makes his ninth appearance. Kicks and the payoff pitch. Misses inside as Young tosses up the hands. And it's a one-out walk. Young, the base runner, 9-1 Owls in the second inning.
DeFabia, only one appearance in the last month. He threw an inning May the 1st against Liberty in which he struck out a batter and did not allow any hits or runs.
Lefty on righty, Spencer Hansen at the dish, and he takes a fastball beneath the hands. 0-1 on Hansen, hit into a double play, 6-4-3 that ended the first. And the offering, swing and a liner sprayed into left field. Keel misplays it past his glove and kicks up against the wall. Cash Young around third base. Here comes the relay home and the tag. Young is out. Estrella with the relay. Preget with the tag. And it stays a 9-1 lead.
DeFabia joined rarefied air for the Hatters in the first start of his career, throwing a shutout in his Stetson debut, joining Brooks Wilson on that list. We mentioned Brooks earlier, AAA with the Braves currently.
Hudson Mims up from the right side. DeFabia delivers, and it's swung on and sent in the air. Cameron Hill in center field camps out underneath it and collects the final out of the inning. Kennesaw State opens up the scoring just like last time with a big second inning. Six runs, six hits, one error, and one stranded. We head to the third, 9-1. Kennesaw State leads on the KSU AL Network. And we're back here at the third inning in game one of three between the Owls and the Hatters, 9-1. Kennesaw State leads. Jack Myers comes out with an 8-run lead here in the third inning. Feels pretty good for a pitcher to be able to work with 8 runs. What do you say, Trey?
Anytime you've got that big of a lead, the biggest thing you want to make sure you do is force contact. Do not give any free base runners, but don't get completely outside your game plan. Do what you do.
Traficante up here out of the two hole, swings the first offering. And a soft chopper up the first baseline. Nick Hassan, the catcher, out to retrieve it 0-1.
And what I mean by that, Jack Myers is a guy who likes to work off of his secondary stuff a little bit. You don't change that game plan, but you know that you can be a little bit more aggressive with this lead.
And the offering, swing and a pop-up out of play, third baseline. 0-2 on Traficante. Stetson coming off a game that went much different than this. The Hatters had plenty of chances in the midweek game as they hosted USF. 0-2, down and away as he lays off. Nice eye there by the Stetson right fielder. But straight at 14 on base in an extra inning loss, took 10 innings to fall to South Florida 4-3. 1-2, runs in the dirt inside, 2 balls and 2 strikes. USF scored in the 8th, 9th, and 10th innings for the rally. Two-two pitch. Fastball away, and the count's full at 3-2.
That's a tale of two ball games leading into this series. As you see the Hatters drop a tough one, Owls come back and win a close one.
Payoff pitch sent back up the chute into center field, and a leadoff base knock in the first hit of the day for Stetson off the bat of Camden Traficante. And here's the left fielder, Connor Keel, who came in for the injured Nick DiPonzio, who went up against a deep fly ball against Tyler Simon, banged up against the window in left field. It was ruled a grand slam. And DiPonzio left with the help of the training staff just to the door, about 5 feet to the right of that wall, to be attended to. So now Keel, hitting 200 on the year. The pitch cut on and missed on a breaking ball outside, 0-1. Keel 5 for 25 with 3 runs driven in. Cash holds on Traficante at first. Middle infield looking for the double play. A few shadows above us here at the shake. The 0-1 pitch is a breaking ball pulled foul to the third base side. 0-2.
You mentioned earlier that Keel spent some time, 2 seasons at Chipola, where he was named an academic All-American playing for legendary head coach Jeff Johnson. multi-time winner of a junior college national championship.
Myers ahead, no balls, two strikes. Checks up on Traficante over at first. He's back in safely. Four stolen bases on the year.
The Hatters are a team that will run even if they're down in the game like they are right here.
Couple of nods. And the 0-2 slider outside. One ball and two strikes. So I feel like we've talked about the stadium a decent amount. We found out how that wall plays with the window in left field jutting out, or jutting back in, I should say, from the padded wall. And then Donovan Cash hitting it off the stairwell, bouncing back into the field of play for his home run. So looking at the dimensions overall, the pitch, swing and a miss. It goes just past Nick Hassan, and that's a strikeout with first base occupied and the second K for Myers. One away for the Hatters here in the third, trailing 9-1. So 330 down the line in right, 330 to left. 400 to center field, but with the batter's eye that is in play, the wall extends about double its height. So if you want to shoot it to straightaway center, you need liftoff. Buller, the first baseman up for the Hatters, stretching the pitch. Fastball misses in, 1-0. 370 to left center, 367 to right center. Bullpen's out of play, but they do a good job eating up a good bit of foul ground, just a skinny sliver of foul ground up the left field and right field side. Prior to reaching the pins, long look for Myers, now time called by Bullard. Plenty of foul ground up from first base and third base. And then not much room to work with for the backstop. We've seen plenty of times where if you got a wild pitch, it might come back like a rebound for the catcher and hold those runners at third. 1-0 is swung on and foul tipped to the mid of Hassan. 1-1 on Bullard.
Some activity already starting down in the Owls bullpen as well, surprisingly. But these teams do have a short week coming back next week, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, to close out the A-Sun Conference play.
Sticks to the board. The 1-1 is a breaking ball that grooves the outer half. 1-2. You're right, for the Owls, it's heading up to Lynchburg and a chance for the A-Sun East Division crown. Owls against the Flames. Depending on how action goes this weekend. Myers, the long stare down. Kicks and fires, and that's away. Backhanded by Hassan, 2-2. So, speaking of that, Trey, what's the A-Sun looking like here this weekend? What are some other key matchups for us to keep an eye on?
Big series on both sides of the A-Sun. The two biggest will be Florida Gulf Coast squaring off against Liberty down in Fort Myers, and then Eastern Kentucky squaring off against Lipscomb on the west side. Have big implications as to positioning for that A-Sun Conference Tournament. This weekend matters a lot as well for both of these teams. Owls trying to position themselves, as you said, to go up to Lynchburg, Virginia next weekend with a chance to win the A-Sun East. Stetson trying to maintain a spot in the conference tournament.
2-2. Dives off the plate and away. 3-2.
Despite being last in the A-Sun East right now, Stetson would be in the conference tournament by way of having a higher RPI than the University of North Florida Ospreys. Even though the Ospreys have beaten them five times this year, they would be in ahead of the Ospreys at this point in time.
9-1 Owls in the third, one on, one out. And the payoff from Jack Myers misses above the shoulders. It's the fourth walk by Myers, now at least one in every inning. And Stetson, for the third straight inning, has two base runners on. So 2-1 with one out for the DH, Juan Correa, 0-for-1 with the ground out, 1-3. So, Trey, fill us in again real quick for those that may not be up to speed with what's different about the tournament this year. First, we'll get the pitch to Correa. It's a sharp breaking ball in the inner half, 0-1. How does this seeding work out? You said RPI and records.
So the top three teams from each division will make the A-Sun tournament, along with the next two highest RPI teams remaining, regardless of division.
0-1 grips the outer half, 0-2.
The way it sits currently, the top three teams for the West would make it in, along with the top three teams from the East, as well as Stetson and Jacksonville would be the two highest RPI teams to also get in.
0-2 pitch, down and away. Correa won't chase. One ball, two strikes.
Once the teams are determined, those eight teams, the two division winners and the two highest RPIs remaining go into Pool A, which we will call the Olympic Pool. The remaining four teams go into Pool B, which you have affectionately dubbed the Kiddie Pool.
Hold up now, Trey. Hold up. 1-2. Swing and a miss. Late bite there from Myers. His second strikeout of the inning, two away. You said we called the Olympic, and then I just called the Kiddie Pool. So that's what we're putting out there on the record?
That is the record. You came up with Kiddie Pool. I came up with Olympic Pool. So three teams will come out of the Olympic Pool down at the conference tournament, and only one, the winner, will come out of the Kiddie Pool to make up the semifinals. The two winners will square off in the championship.
Kyle Ball, the third baseman, swings the first offering, sends the breaking ball in the air, down the line and right. A trio of owls won't get there as it lands foul, 0-1. You know, Trey, just because I like you, I guess I'll let you in when we bring out the Walmart Kiddie Pool that we talked about on Wednesday. We bring that to Fort Myers and we watch the other games.
Well, that's another thing that these teams will have to contend with that do get down to Fort Myers. Not only do you have a short week next week playing Thursday, Friday, Saturday, the conference tournament the following week starts on Tuesday. So you could have a situation where your pitchers have back-to-back short weeks to be ready to pitch.
Two on, two outs, 9-1 Owls in the third. The pitch from Jack Myers is a fastball, good on the outside corner, 0-2.
And what we've learned over the course of the last decade, or at least what I've learned, is anything can happen in that conference tournament. You look at last year, Jacksonville did not win a conference series and ended up winning the conference tournament, so anything can happen.
Righty's 0-2. Check swing, tapper, softly shot to the on-deck circle. Desereau picks it up. The count remains no balls and two strikes on the Stetson third baseman, Kyle Ball.
And if you're a Hatters fan and you're tuning in and listening to us on YouTube, you will remember fondly the 2016 team that entered as the last seed in the tournament and stormed through with four straight victories to make a regional.
0-2 from Myers. Swinging a ground ball, shot foul, third base side.
I unfortunately remember that one so well because we had won the conference regular season championship for the first time. We were at the 2016 Owls, or the team that this team is trying to beat in terms of conference wins. We finished that season 17-4, and Stetson knocked us off in game one up at Lipscomb that year.
Owls 15-9 in the A-Sun entering today, and the 0-2 is looked at off the dish. One ball, two strikes.
It wasn't all bad in 2016 as we did get eliminated in two games. I was home that following week and able to see my daughter being born rather than playing in a regional. Hard to believe that's coming up on 6 years ago.
One, two pitch. A breaking ball sent the opposite way into right field, in for a base hit. Edson cuts it off at the line, and he throws it into second base. Stetson able to put one back on the board. A nice piece of hitting with two strikes by Kyle Ball serving into right field. An RBI knock. Traficante comes in to score. Bowler takes third base and they're on the corners with two away.
On the corners for who many believe will be one of the next great hitters to wear a Hatter uniform, Johan Desereau, the kid out of Canada, who spent his last year of prep baseball in Florida at TNXL Academy.
0-1 with a strikeout, righty on lefty, and Myers misses away, 1-0. Part of the Canadian junior national team that plays an exhibition game against Stetson every fall. So Stetson has its eyes north of the border every year. One of two Canadians in the roster, another was looked at but ultimately signed before deciding to go to DeLand. The pitch has popped up out of play, 1-1.
And that's how recruiting has changed since Steve Tremper is taking the job. His Northeast ties have meant that they brought in a lot more Northeastern players from Canada, not as much Florida as it used to be for the Hatters.
On the corners with two outs, 9-2 KSU in the third. Myers delivers. Swing and a foul tip in the upper half of the zone, 1-2.
Desiree was actually a player that I saw and recruited a little bit. Saw some video on him. Really liked the swing.
Myers nods. Roddy fires. Swinging a fly ball, foul ground, over towards third. Cash Young racing over against the wall, but it's out of play.
And that one ends up in the land of balls that do not return over there by the apartments. Now I'm convinced there's a hole over there that has about 1,000 baseballs in it that one day we'll uncover and figure out where they all get to.
You bringing the shovels in July? Another 1-2 from Myers. Swing and a miss. Foul tipped in the mid of his son as he chases him up and away. Myers strikes out the side, but Stetson secures its second run of the day on the two-out single by Kyle Ball. For the Hatters, one run, two base hits, no errors, and a couple of Hatters stranded. Bottom three coming up at Stillwell Stadium. 9-2 Owls over the Hatters on the KSU Owl Network. Bottom of the third inning, 9-2. Kennesaw State leads Stetson here at home. Here on senior weekend for the Owls, senior day tomorrow for Kennesaw State. The 2 o'clock start, Trey Fowler and Michael Goss will have the call for you. Trey joining me here today, Nolan Alexander with you. The Owls scored 6 runs in the last half inning, chasing out the Stetson starter. DeFabio back in for a second inning of work against Nick Hassan, who issues a strike in the southpaw ahead here, 0-1. Works in a split second, and the pitch is grounded hard to third. Ball knocks it down, picks it up, throws to first. Hassan retired, but ball is shaken up. That one squared and nubbed right to the midsection of ball.
That one's hit right on the button. Another good at bat by Nick Hassan, and it'll take a minute for Kyle Ball to regain his composure as an already banged up Hatters team. A team that lost two of their top arms before the season ever began, have several others fighting through injuries, trying to make it down the stretch and get this team into the conference tournament where anything can happen.
Now when it rains, it pours. Nick DiPanzio, the left fielder, left injured in the second inning. Braden Edson up out of the nine hole. He takes downstairs 1-0. 9-2 KSU, Owls batting here. Bases empty, one out in the home half of the third. Lefty on lefty, the offering. Misses up and in near the wrist, 2-0.
And if you're the Owls here, you have to keep the foot on the gas. You got to keep scoring every inning they score.
DeFabio, high kick, 2-0 pitch, chopper right side of the infield. Plucked by Billard, he flips to the covering pitcher. DeFabio wins the foot race and a 3-1 put out, 2 away. Josh Hatcher, 1-for-2 with a single. DeFabia pitched against Kennesaw State on the 8th. down in DeLand. Two innings, four hits, three runs, two earned, one walk and three strikeouts. And his first pitch to Hatcher is swung on and missed, 0-1. The offering away, one ball and one strike. He last pitched at home against Liberty on May the 1st, went one inning against the Flames. Clean work with a strikeout. And this pitch is fouled as Hatcher falls to one knee, and it's shot towards the Owls' dugout. 1-2 on the Owls' center fielder.
And DeVabia is working very fast like most Hatter pitchers do. They're unique in that they let their catcher call pitches, so it usually moves pretty quick.
1-2. Swing and a foul by Hatcher, out of play, third base side. He's ready, the offering. Swing and a ball popped off the hands and out of play. Waiting out to land towards us. Guess it missed the press box. Wind up the offering. Swing and a ground ball nubbed to first. Plucked on the ground by Bullard. And again, he flips to the covering pitcher. Back-to-back 3-1 putouts. And the Hatters have their first 1-2-3 inning of the day. To the fourth we go, 9-2. Kennesaw State leads Stetson on the KSU Owl Network. On to the fourth inning, a new pitcher on the mound, a new man on the mic. Nolan Alexander turning over the play-by-play duties here to Trey Fowler.
Luke Torbert's the new arm here for the Owls. Torbert will be making his 18th appearance on the year. 2-1, 7.50 ERA, 42 innings pitched, 48 hits, 35 runs, all earned. 19 walks, 43 strikeouts. Opponents hitting .294 against him. Close the book on Mr. Myers. Three innings pitched for him. Two hits, two runs, four walks, and four strikeouts. So a short outing for Mr. Myers today. And Torbert will be the man in charge for the Owls when we get back to play here in the top of the fourth. Owls on top 9-2. Big weekend here for both teams as the Owls look to hopefully gain ground. If you're them, you hope that the Florida Gulf Coast can protect their home turf down there in Fort Myers against visiting Liberty. And if so, it'll give the Owls a chance to climb back into first place in the A-Sun East. At worst, they would like to maintain right where they're at and pace the Flames in wins this weekend so that they can have a chance to go up and win this series. And hopefully the second time is the charm, as the Owls had the same circumstance last year looking to win the A-Sun regular season, headed to Liberty and was swept in Lynchburg. Leading off the inning for the Hatters is going to be the catcher, Pregent. Torbert sets and delivers a first-pitch breaking ball for strike number one. 9 runs, 10 hits for the Owls so far through 3 innings. 2 runs and 2 hits for the Hatters. Torbert, exclusively out of the stretch, delivers the 0-1, fouled over by the Owls' dugout. And on one hop, tomorrow's starter, John Bezdacek, will catch it, flip it to Slade Notterman, and it'll make its way back into the game ball bucket. Torbert quickly ahead, 0-2. The 0-2, that one's rolled out the short. Simon's got it on a backhand. He throws on the run. A nice stretch on the other end by Donovan Cash for out number one.
Trey, he just makes it look easy, doesn't he?
That was as effortless as you will see that play made. Backhand running away and flips it over there to Donovan Cash. So a nice first out for the Owls here in the top of the fourth, and that'll bring up the shortstop, Andrew Estrella. Estrella reached on an error by Cash Young in his first at bat. First pitch to him, swing and a miss. 0-1. Estrella fighting through an injury himself. He wears a brace when he's on defense. They have to take it off when he hits. 0-1 pitch. That one's fouled down the third baseline past third base coach Steve Tremper. I think that just speaks to this kid's toughness, the ability to be able to go through that, still play really good defense. Had a huge home run that helped them win a game over Florida State earlier this year. The 0-2 from Torbert. That one's in the dirt. Nice block there by Hassan. They'll ask down to first base umpire Creel Waddell, who says that he did not go. Count will be 1-2.
In that Florida State game, the highlight of the season so far for Stetson, 6-0 shutout win over the Noles.
1-2. Breaking ball. Catches him looking. Strike three. And Hassan will throw that one around the horn. Strikeout number one for Torbert. Number five overall for the Owls.
And you knew there Estrella was either thinking completely different location or different pitch, because that breaking ball was right down the middle. A great one there from Torbert with the late bite falling below the knees after it crossed the zone. Very good pitch.
Bring up the leadoff hitter Cameron Hill, 0-1, but did score a run. He tries to bunt for a base hit. Pouncing off the mound is Torbert. Bare hand fires to first. He's out. And that will end your fourth inning. A 1-2-3 top of the fourth for the Owls. We head to the bottom half. Owls on top, 9-2 here on the KSU Owl Network. And we are back here on the KSU Owl Network. It's time again for This Day in Owl History. May the 13th, 2011, Kennesaw State knocked off UNF in the first game of a three-game series down at Harmon Stadium, 10-4. Leading the way offensively were Sean McClurkin with three hits and three RBIs and Peyton Hart, who had three hits and two RBIs. 28th round draft pick of the Tigers, Josh Carr, in the wind on the mound with eight innings pitched, allowing only a single earned run, while Sean Freem got the final three outs in the ninth. That's May the 13th, 2011, This Day in Owls History.
Does it scare you sometimes to think 2011 was 11 years ago now?
Long time. That was before my Owls tenure, but I know Peyton Hart very well. Now he's the head coach up in North Georgia. Simon steps in. First pitch to him is downstairs. DeFabia still on the mound for the Hatters. Peyton was on that first team that I coached here in 2013. He was the captain, still affectionately known, I'm sure, by most of his teammates as captain. 1-0 pitch outside with an off-speed pitch, 2-0.
Here's the current captain sitting halfway to the cycle.
His high school teammates got two on the year. He wants one as well. That one's rolled over to short. Estrella has it, fires across the diamond for out number one. So he shows off that strong arm right there for the first out of the bottom of the fourth. Owls lead 9-2, three in the first, six in the second. Allows them to build this lead, and that'll bring up Zach Corbin taking his first at bat of the day from the right side of the plate. One for two from the left side. Singled and scored in the first. Grounded out in the second. That one's fouled out of play. DeFabia still working quick and still working ahead of these Owls hitters. Wind and the 0-1. Fouled back off the screen. 0-2. That one will be picked up by Donovan Cash. He's doing it all lately, ladies and gentlemen. Stretching at first base, hitting, picking up the foul balls. I saw him brooming out the dugout the other night, I think.
Is he going to join you with a shovel to retrieve the hole of baseballs?
0-2, hit out to short. Estrella's got this one, drops it, picks it up. Not going to be in time. Cannot bobble it on a man as fast as Zach Corbin, and that'll go down as an E6. You know what I envision on those balls is that scene from The Sandlot where they go back there at the end and mm-hmm. they find all those balls that the Beast had stored up and taken. Mm-hmm. That's what I envision. That's around here somewhere. We just got to uncover it. So the Owls have one on with one out here for Cash. 2 for 2 on the day, double and a homer. A couple of RBIs and a couple of runs scored. The pitch outside for a ball, 1-0. Cash's fifth multi-hit game in a row, 23 on the year for the redshirt freshman out of Sharpsburg, Georgia. Waves the bat high over the head, the 1-0. That one's inside, 2-0. Nice crowd here tonight at Stillwell Stadium on senior weekend. Those guys will be honored tomorrow afternoon, 8 of them up for the Owls. 2-0 pitch, outside again, 3-0. We appreciate everyone joining in on YouTube. We'll have a little trivia for you later, and today's question will pertain to both the Hatters and the Owls. It's one of my favorite questions to ask. 3-0 pitch, this one catches the corner, 3-1.
What's the season scoreboard total, Trey?
Of correct answers?
Who's winning this year? We have a fan on top?
Oh, we definitely have a fan on top. John is the fan on top, no doubt about it. 3-1 pitch. That one's rolled over to short on a backhand by Estrella. He will not have a play, and we'll see how they score that one. Personally, I think it's got to be an infield hit, as he just couldn't quite make the transfer. Was going to try and go to second base there, and that was not going to be in time as a speedy Zach Corbin was motoring down the line.
I'm in agreement. I'm leaning towards hit on that as well. And Estrella's had to work for just about everything this inning. KSU is, it seemed like, okay, let's go back here in the fourth inning, shoot everything over at the shortstop, you know, has an injured shoulder, and see what he can do.
Cash Young steps in 1-for-1 with a walk on the day. First pitch to him. Outside, 1-0. So mentioned before, the Owls need to keep putting runs on the board. The last thing you want is to turn this into a game where you get stuck on 9 and let the Hatters climb back a run at a time. 1-0 pitch, also outside, 2-0. For the fan that asks if there is a mercy rule in this game, there is not. The only time a mercy rule is in place in A-Sun play is in game 1 of a doubleheader that takes place on the last day of the series. 2-0, that one's lying down the left field line. This one will get into the Owls bullpen and out of play. 2-1 the count on Cash Young.
And that happened in a game KSU would like to forget.
Liberty University here at Stillwell Stadium. Game 2 of that series did end in a run rule victory for the Flames. If memory serves me correctly, it has happened twice in the last decade, once against the Flames and once up at Lipscomb the last weekend of the 2013 season. 2-1. Check swing. He went. That'll even the count at 2-2. That was a season in 2013 where the Owls made it to their second consecutive A-Sun Tournament Championship game before falling to ETSU and Phenom Kerry Doan. The third time would be the charm when the Owls won in 2014 versus Lipscomb. 2-2 pitch. downstairs, even runs the count full at 3-2. And that's something I was talking to Bo Way before the game. The conference tournament this year is in Fort Myers, first time it has returned since 2014. And the Owls are hoping that history repeats itself, as that's where they won the 2014 conference tournament, where Brennan Morgan was named conference tournament MVP. 3-2 pitch. That one's lined deep into left field, but it's going to bend foul. We'll do the 3-2 one more time, as the Owls' leader in home runs and one of the conference's top five in home runs bends that just foul. You know, Nolan, one thing that I'm interested to see this year out of the A-Sun is who they name Conference Player of the Year. There are so many deserving candidates this year. It's incredible. You have two on this Owls bunch with Cash Young and Josh Hatcher. 3-2 pitch outside, ball four, and the bases will be loaded for the Owls. But then you take a look around the league in Florida Gulf Coast, the man we saw last weekend have such a huge weekend against the Owls with 12 RBIs. You go to Bellarmine and you have Higgins, who's 20 home runs now. He's almost winning the A-Sun Triple Crown. In my opinion, he's got to be the front runner, but a lot of great candidates. First pitch to Hansen's fouled back to the screen. 0-1.
Well, I'm going to honor the paycheck today and say that my votes are for, if I had a vote, would be split between Cash and Hatch.
Well, you can only nominate one, so it's going to be interesting to see who the coaching staff decides to nominate. 0-1 pitch downstairs. Evens the count at 1-1.
But look, the A-Sun at times has bent rules and made little caveats and everything. See if we could sneak in a second nomination.
Well, that's what you don't want to do, because you don't want them splitting votes. 1-1 pitch upstairs, 2-1.
But, Trey, we're going off these rules that I have here where, you know, I get to vote and I get to split votes as well.
Well, if you were the Owls coaching staff and you had to pick one of those two guys, who would it be?
Oh, man. Let me think on it.
Tough one.
Cash Hatcher.
You also have Uhl up at Eastern Kentucky, who's having a monster year. Just so many great players this year. 2-1 pitch. Fouled back to the screen, 2-2.
So, Trey, I have a question for you on that, actually, from a former coach. Do coaches within the league talk about that at all? Do they discuss who they think should get something, or do they ever call up a guy and say, hey, who are you voting for here? Does that ever happen?
Not really. A lot of guys kind of keep that to themselves. 2-2 pitch downstairs, runs the count full, 3-2. It's something that, you know, there have been years where you look at the voting and you're like, how did this happen? I think a prime example of that was back in 2019 when the two guys who I thought had the best chance to win it, 3-2, that one's lined into left field. That one is deep, and that one is going to be over the wall. A grand slam home run, second of the day for the Owls, and first for Spencer Hansen. That will be Hansen's third home run of the year. Give him RBIs 28, 29, 30, and 31.
Well, Trey, for this Owls offense, don't have a great day. Have a grand day. Hansen, the freshman, sends liftoff.
Hansen lined that one over the left field wall. It was hard to tell if that one was going to get out or not. Now the Owls are going to pinch hit here for Hudson Mims, and they're going to go to Nick Kalina. And this is very interesting here, Nolan, as this could mean the return of Zach Corbin to the infield, which we haven't seen since very early in the year. First pitch to Corbin's down, or first pitch to Kalina is down for a ball, 1-0. Working very fast still is DeFabia. Evens the count at 1-1. 1-1, swing and a miss by Kalina. 1-2 with one out here in the bottom of the fourth. Owls striking for four more, running the lead to 13-2. That one's outside. Evens the count at 2-2.
Well, Trey, what if I told you Kennesaw State's going to hit two grand slams in the first four innings, and it's off the bats of Hansen and Simon?
The 2-2 pitch there swung on and missed. That'll be out number two. If you told me they were going to hit a grand slam, obviously the first person you look for is Josh Hatcher, who's hit three already this year. But it being senior weekend, Tyler Simon would not surprise you at all. He's had a great career in an Owl uniform, and he is looking to close it out in a great way. Nick Hassan up to the plate, takes ball one downstairs. Hassan bunt single, which really got everything going in the second. 1-0 upstairs, 2-0. And then he lined one off of Kyle Ball last time up. That one's lined into center field. That'll be a base hit. We mentioned it. Nick Hassan is starting to get back to that freshman All-American form. Saw him after the game the other night. Talked to him for a few minutes. He seemed in great spirits. He seemed very happy. And that is a good sign for the Owls. Kind of get back to what we were talking about A-Sun Player of the Year, all-conference voting. Coaches really don't talk a whole lot about that. Well, I was mentioning 2019, in which I felt like you look at who won Conference Player of the Year, and no knock on Embry. Jonathan, I think his name was Jonathan Embry out of Liberty at all. He was the leader of that team. They were the best team in the league that year, and no knock on him at all. But if you look at the numbers of a guy like Jake Franklin, who was nominated from Kennesaw State, who hit double-digit home runs at the top in the league in home runs, RBIs, batting average. And Florida Gulf Coast also had a guy, and his name escapes me at the moment, I'll find it, that led the conference in conference batting average, hitting over nearly 500 in conference play. And you look at those two things and you wonder, how could this happen? Back in 2013, the Owls had Steven Janis, who was 9-0. Set the A-Sun ERA record for a single season and did not win Conference Pitcher of the Year. Lost out to Kerry Doan from ETSU, who I think was 12-1 at the time when the voting came in. Now, Kerry Doan would go on to beat Steven Janis head-to-head in the 2013 Conference Tournament Championship game, which many believe maybe that justified, but I don't see how you can have an award go to someone who – or not go to someone who was undefeated, 9-0, set the ERA title in the league. That's one where if I'm the A-Sun commissioner and I look at that voting, these guys got to split that pitcher of the year.
Trey, you just gave me another reason with that historical nugget not to like ETSU. That's perfectly fine with me.
Got a new pitcher here on the mound for the Hatters as they go to the bullpen here for the second time in the fourth inning. And this will be the transfer from Clemson University by way of Wofford. And that's going to be Rashish Panda. And he'll face Braden Edson. Nick Hassan on first. He singled. Chase DeFabia. This ball is hit high into right field. Ranging over is Traficante. He'll make the catch for out number three. But not before the Owls use a Spencer Hansen grand slam to extend their lead to 13-2 as we head to the fifth here on the KSU Owl Network.
Number 10, Zach Corbett.
And we are back here on the KSU Owl Network. Trey Fowler joined in the booth by Nolan Alexander. Owls on top 13-2 as we head to the fifth. Luke Torbert still on the mound for the Owls. He came in relief of starter Jack Myers an inning ago. Some defensive changes. Nick Kalina goes out to left, and for the first time since the beginning of the year, Zach Corbin comes in to play second base as Kalina pinch hit for Hudson Mims. Due up for Stetson will be 2-3-4 in the order. Right fielder Camden Traficante will start him off. First pitch from Torbert is lined into center field. In comes Hatcher, still coming, still coming. He'll make the catch right at the letters for out number one. So a quick first out here in the fifth inning for the Owls, and that'll bring up Connor Keel, who came into the game for Nick DiPonzio when he crashed into the wall on that Tyler Simon grand slam. Still no word on him yet. Have not seen him come back out. But hopefully he is okay. First pitch to Keel, outside and high for a ball, 1-0. Keel struck out in his first at-bat since entering the game. That one was off starter Jack Myers. He'll face Torbert here in the 1-0 pitch, way outside, 2-0. The game that the Owls will be watching closely starts here right now. Down in Fort Myers, a 6:30 start between the Eagles and Flames. 2-0 is way outside and all the way to the backstop, 3-0. That series will have a lot of implications on what the Owls might have to do 1 week from now as they travel up to Lynchburg University to claim that number one seed in the A-Sun East. 3-0. That one's upstairs, and that'll be ball four as Keel will head down to first base with a walk. Jacob Bullard will step to the plate, the first baseman, 0-for-1 on the day. He scored the Hatters' run back in the first with a ground out to second base, walked in his next at-bat in the third inning. Hatters jumped on top 1-0 before the Owls scored three times on four hits in the bottom of the first and then six times in the second. First pitch to Bullard, another one misses down and away, the fifth wide one in a row from Torbert. One-oh pitch. That one's right through there for a strike. 1-1. Once again, we appreciate everyone tuning in on YouTube and your interaction. We love to hear from you. I have a nice trivia question coming your way here in a couple innings that pertains to both teams. 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss on the cutter. 1-2 as Torbert quickly jumps ahead of Bullard. 13 runs, 13 hits, and one error for the Owls. 2-2-2 for the Hatters. Long hold by Torbert. The 1-2. This one stays high and in with the breaking ball. 2-2. Nice crowd here for senior weekend. Mostly look like Owls fans, as it doesn't appear many made the trip up from DeLand. 2-2's fouled back to the screen. And over to the on-deck circle where Juan Correa waits. He'll pick it up and flip it to Stetson Hatter pitching coach Dave Thurneau. We'll take a look at it. Torbert sets at the belly button and the 2-2 upstairs for a ball. Count full again, 3-2. Owls wearing their typical Friday night attire, white pinstripes with black Owls across the chest outlined in gold. Stetson in their road grays with green across the chest and their numbers on the back. 3-2, fouled off. We'll do it one more time. Count remains full. Pretty day. It's been pretty all week here in Kennesaw. Not a ton of rain in the forecast. That one swung on and missed for strike three and out number two here in the top of the fifth inning. So Bullard unable to lay off a pitch way out of the zone that would have been ball four, and that'll bring up Correa with two outs and Keel still standing down at first base. Correa 0 for 2, ground out of the mound and a strikeout. Swings and misses and foul tips the first pitch for strike number one.
Well, Trey, you're talking about the weather. I took a peek at the forecast for next week. Have you seen it yet?
I have not.
It's going to get up to 94 next Wednesday.
Sounds like a good day to stay inside. Catch up on some Lincoln Lawyer and Bosch Legacy. 0-1 pitch inside. This one may have clipped Correa. It did right on the shirt sleeve. And he will head down to first base with the Hatters' second hit-by-pitch of the day. The first for Torbert. And once again, two runners on for the Hatters. They've had two runners on in every inning but the fourth. Torbert's first inning that went 1-2-3. Every other inning they've had at least two base runners. Kyle Ball steps in. 1-for-2. He doubled in a run his last at bat. Tucked one in the right field corner. First pitch down and away, ball one. Kyle Ball making his 192nd career appearance in a Stetson Hatter uniform. Mentioned before, he was the first Stetson commit under Steve Tremper. 1-0. That one in there for a strike on the cutter, 1-1. He was originally committed to Maine, where Tremper was the head coach before taking the Hatter job in December of 2016. One pitch. That one's fouled back. 1-2. 2017 was set to be the final season for legendary Stetson Hatter head coach Pete Dunn, but he retired early after the fall was over. The Hatters were set to host the 2017 conference tournament, which they did. 1-2 pitch. That one's chopped out to short, backing up on an assignment. He'll go the short way, and he'll get out number three as he flips to Zach Corbin, who finds his way back on the infield. We will head to the bottom of the fifth. Owl still on top, 13-2 here on the KSU Owl Network. We're back here, bottom of the fifth. Pandia still on the mound for the Hatters. He will face the top of the Owl order, Hatcher, Simon, and Corbin. Hatcher is 1-for-3 on the day, grounded out to first base a couple of times and singled in a run in the second inning. First pitch to him, lined foul as he's way ahead of a breaking ball. The 0-1, that one down and away, 1-1. Now you've jokingly talked about this kiddie pool and bringing it out at the conference tournament. What I'm going to need you to do and help with, the 1-1 pitch, swing and a miss, good change up there by Pandia. What I'm going to need you to do is be on alligator patrol, because there are gators prevalent around that stadium, Swanson Stadium there at Fort Myers. So I'm going to need you to look out for those for me. 1-2, lined into center field. That's going to get down for a base hit. Over to cut it off quickly is Cameron Hill, and he will flip it back in and keep Hatcher at first.
And you're right, cut it off quickly, because Hatcher had his eyes on a double. Hatcher's a guy that hit over 400 for a decent amount of the season, has dipped under it, by goodness, but is on his way to trying to get back to that 400 mark. But, Trey, you say jokingly, I have full intentions of bringing this kiddie pool out, and I'll be happy to be on alligator duty for you.
First pitch to Simon. Simon is 2-for-3 on the day with that grand slam. He takes ball one outside, 1-0. Scored a couple runs, 4 RBIs, also grounded out to short his last time up. 1-0 pitch, another breaking ball off the plate, 2-0.
Have you seen a gator out there?
I have not, but our bus driver, his name was Mike, circa 2018, did see one. 2-0 pitch, outside and low, 3-0. And provided he wasn't telling a tall tale, they are in existence out there beyond that field.
You know who we will have to keep an eye out for down there the entire time, even though we're not playing?
3-0 downstairs. Ball four. Owls have runners on first and second with nobody out.
The infamous Florida man, who's always in the news.
I don't know that I know who that is.
Oh, Trey, we're going to be in for fun. There's this old Twitter account. I don't think he operates it anymore. It's called @FloridaMan. Because you hear about it in the news every day, right? Every day. If you turn on the news, you listen to the radio, you haven't seen national news. Florida man does something insane. So it's a list of all these things that happened in the state of Florida from the Florida man. We'll go look and see what the Florida man's been up to.
First pitch to Corbin is downstairs. 1-0 as Corbin flips back around to the left side. He's 1-for-3 on the day. Reached on an error, singled, scored a couple of times, and also grounded out to third base on a tremendous play by Kyle Ball.
Well, Florida man hasn't tweeted since 2019, and just quickly looking at it, he got into some political things, so we'll just scoot back into yesteryear.
1-0. That one's hit over to second base. Nice play by Desereau. He throws that one away, and that will load the bases. So a nice sliding stop on the knees by Desereau, but his throw back to second base, trying to get the force out on Tyler Simon, just out of the stretching Estrella, and that'll load the bases for Donovan Cash. And could we see grand slam number 3 here in this ballgame?
Stage is set for it. If anyone's going to do it, it's the red-hot Donovan Cash.
3-for-3 on the day, triple short of the cycle. First pitch to him downstairs for a ball, 1-0. Cash not the fastest guy. I think if he's going to hit one, he might have to tuck it in the right field corner or hit one high off that center field wall. 1-0. That one's right through there for a strike, 1-1.
Trey, I'm not going to steal your thunder in case he hits a grand slam here, but I got some good Florida man stories for you when the time comes.
The 1-1 pitch lined over a leaping Kyle Ball and into left field. That will score Hatcher. That will score Simon. Across the third is Corbin and give him double number 2 and his second consecutive 4-hit game, and we're only in the fifth. As Donovan Cash is making his case, not only for Freshman of the Year in the A-Sun, but A-Sun Player of the Week.
You think it's at least the size of a beach ball to him right now, Trey?
I'm not quite sure. I mean, obviously Josh Hatcher was seeing the ball like this early in the year when he had 2 cycles in a week and he was named National Player of the Week, but for a freshman, I'm not sure that I can remember a time in which a freshman is seeing the ball as well as Donovan Cash is right now. Now, Tyler Simon was a All-American as a freshman. He had a really good stretch that freshman year after he came in for the injured Jalen Smith. But Donovan Cash is seeing it well right now. When you're seeing it as good as he is, whatever you're doing, you continue to do. He might be one of those guys that eats the same meal every time before every game, and it's working. So no need to change anything now. We've got a new pitcher coming on for the Hatters. We'll tell you all about him when we come back right after this on the KSU Owl Network. And we are back here on the KSU Owl Network. Bottom of the fifth, Owls now on top, 15-2. And they have runners at second and third for a new Hatter hurler, and that is going to be the graduate student, 6'200", Nick Cesari from Albany, New York. So you said you had some stories. Now I'm going to go with, since he hadn't tweeted since 2019, that a Gator got him. That's what I'm going to go with.
Maybe. Gator or pre-Elon Musk got him. I'm not sure what happened. But here's some good ones. December 30th, 2018. Florida man intentionally locks keys in car so cops can't search it.
Cash Young will be the first one Mr. Cesari faces with these runners on second, third, and still nobody out here in the fifth. Swing and a mammoth hack by Cash Young, and needless to say, he was not looking for the single there. He wants to get in on the extra base hit party, as he is one for one on the day with a couple of walks. He did single and had a couple RBIs back in the first. 0-1's inside, evens the count at 1-1.
Florida man steals Christmas wreath off neighbor's door, hangs it on his own.
1-1 the count on Cash Young. Sets the bat just above the shoulder and check swings. He says he did go, says home plate umpire Lee Ishman. And that'll make the count 1-2 on Young.
This one takes the cake right here, though. Florida man caught shoplifting during Cole's job interview. But that's not the best part.
1-2. Foul down the right field line. That's one way to ensure, well, if he was actually applying for a security job, that might be a good way to get the job.
Well, it says in the story, the sheriff's office says Breedlove did not get the job, in case that was in question.
I mean, I think that would be justification to make him a security guard. 1-2 the count. Cesari sets below the belt and delivers. That one's lined into center field. It's going to get down. In comes Corbin. Also rounding third is Cash. He's headed to the plate. He will score. So another two RBI single on the day for Cash Young. Give him four RBIs on the day and make that his 53rd of the year.
So this unofficially ties the most runs Kennesaw State has scored against Stetson with 17 against the Hatters in what's the score now, a 17-2 win here in 2012 on April the 13th.
I'll bring up Hansen. Grand slam his last at bat. Takes strike one here. He's also singled and wrapped into a double play that ended inning number one. The 0-1 pitch from Cesari. Chopped foul over by the on-deck circle, where head coach Ryan Coe catches it on one hop behind the back to Nick Hassan, who lays it up for Slade Notterman. 17 runs, 16 hits, one error for the Owls, 2-2-3 now for the Hatters. That one stays high, 1-2. Spencer Hansen, the Tallahassee Community College transfer. His alma mater made the Florida Junior College postseason, but were knocked off in the first round. 1-2. That one chop foul, and that one almost got a piece of third base coach Derek Tucker as it ricocheted off the dugout post, where Kyle Ball picks it up and flips it back in the dugout.
Can I get you for one more Florida man story?
Let's
see. It's from DeLand.
Okay.
This is Halloween 2018. I'll wait after the pitch.
1-2. That one off the hands, out beyond a leaping Estrella and into center field. Give Hansen his third hit of the ball game.
The only thing I can say about this for Kennesaw State right now is I hope the Owls don't use up their entire run allotment here today.
How many times do you see that, though? You score 20 on Friday, you come back, you lose a 2-1 ball game on Saturday. They hope that is not the script that we get this weekend.
So last one, but I encourage you in the chat if you have your own Florida man story. Firefighters rescue Florida man who climbed down well to prove he can get back out.
First pitch to Kalina. That ball's hit high and deep to right field. He flips, and that ball's gone. A 3-run home run for Nick Kalina. Give the Owls their fourth home run of the day.
Nick Kalina says, I got enough confidence we're going to score enough this weekend. Give me a shot at the 20 bill.
Owls lead here in the fifth. And in will step Nick Hassan. First pitch to him, right through there for a strike, 0-1. Hassan, a couple of hits on the day, and I would argue one of the biggest, his bunt single back in the second that put runners at first and second at the time. 0-1, skips in there, evens the count at 1-1. And we said it going into the game on Wednesday night against Western Carolina. He's the guy that's got to get going. He started to get going last weekend with four hits against Florida Gulf Coast. And he's maintained that this week, and that ball's hit high and deep into right center field. Back to the track. That one's off the wall. Hassan hits first, and he'll coast into second with a double, his third hit of the ball game.
Oh, just casually, the sixth hit of the inning, 19th of the day for Kennesaw State. Still with not a single out here in the fifth inning.
That is the eighth consecutive man to reach in the inning. Single, single, fielder's choice error that they could not get an out on. Double, single, single, home run, and double. Just a triple shy of the cycle in the inning. First pitch to Edson is a strike on the outside corner, 0-1. Edson also had a bunt single back in the second inning that loaded the bases at the time and set the stage for Tyler Simon's first grand slam of the day. 0-1, that was nubbed out towards third base, and it'll spin foul and out of play.
So we already have some season highs for Kennesaw State. 20 runs, that's a high. Coming up on hits, 20 hits against UNF. That was on March the 26th. The 20 RBI for Kennesaw State is a high as well.
0-2, swing and a miss, and that will be out number one here in the fifth inning as Chisari gets Edson swinging.
Yeah, broadcaster's jinx. I said not a single out.
And that will bring up Josh Hatcher. Hatcher started the inning with a single. Came around to score on a double by Donovan Cash. He's 2-for-4 on the day with a couple of ground outs to first base as well. First pitch to him, a mammoth hack here. And it's fouled back to the screen, 0-1. No balls, one strike, one out here. Nick Hassan stands down at second base after his double off the right center field wall. 0-1 to Hatcher. That one's popped up into left field, overcomes Keel, He'll settle underneath it. When it comes down, it will be out number two. Nice play there by Connor Keel, hanging with that sky-high pop-up off the bat of Hatcher. And that will bring up Tyler Simon. Simon singled in the first, grand slam in the second, has also grounded out to short and added another single in this inning. Three hits on the day. First pitch to him, paints the outside corner for strike number one. Cesari leans in, gets his sign, takes the ball from it behind his back, settles it in the glove, and the 0-1 foul back to the screen, 0-2. And I'm not sure who this guy is running up the stairs here, Nolan, but I have never seen a KSU staff member work harder for foul balls than that guy. I petition that he gets a raise. I'm not sure what he's getting paid, but he deserves more.
He's loving it today. He's doing a great job.
0-2 the count here on Simon. The 0-2 upstairs, 1-2. One ball, two strikes, two outs, bottom of the fifth. Owls on top, 20-2. And if you're just joining in, I said 20-2. Here's the pitch. Downstairs, I want to skip all the way to the backstop, and Hassan will move up to third base. We mentioned that Pregent has had to catch most of the season, and he is in there for the duration and the long haul for these Hatters as their backup catcher suffered injury, that being Daniel Labrador, who was having a nice year before he got hurt. 2-2 pitch outside. He runs the count full to 3-2 on Simon. Waiting on deck is Zach Corbin. Got somebody on YouTube that won $1,000, they say. That ball's lined into center field off the bat of Tyler Simon, and it'll be caught by Cameron Hill to end the inning, but not before the Owls add seven more on the strength of a three-run home run off the bat of Nick Kalina. A 2-RBI double by Donovan Cash and a 2-RBI single by Cash Young. We head to the sixth here on the KSU Owl Network. All Owls, 20-2. And we are back here on the KSU Owl Network. Top of six from Kennesaw. Owls on top 20-2. And one defensive change for the Owls. Joseph Gossett, the junior from Pickens County High School in Georgia, out of Jasper, Georgia, is in the game to play left field. Braden Edson's day is now done. Nick Kalina, who just hit the three-run homer, will kick over to right field. And while we're waiting for the drag to finish up, I'm going to give you the trivia question a little early today, give you a chance to have some time to answer this one. in the history of the series between the Owls and the Hatters, which players own the most hits against the other team in the history of the series? 48 games have been played going into today between the Owls and Hatters. Which Owl has the most hits against the Hatters? Which Hatter has the most hits against the Owls?
Well, Trey, the answer may change by the end of this ball game.
First pitch from Torbert's low for a ball, 1-0. There is a man that is climbing up that list that is playing in this game, but he's got a little work to do yet to reach the guy sitting at the top for the Owls. 1-0 pitch outside, 2-0. Got a pinch hitter here for the Hatters. It's going to be Austin Amaral. 3-0 the count. Torbert on for his third inning of work. So far, two scoreless. And that one remains high for a ball. And I'm sorry, that was Banks Griffith. Banks Griffith, the Gainesville, Georgia product. Jeremy Kemp, his former head coach, he transferred to Stetson from Furman after that program was shut down. This will bring up number 29, Craig Paladar, who will spell Christian Pregent behind the plate. First pitch to Paladar, check swing. Home plate umpire says he went. That'll make the count 0-1.
So if you want to answer Trey's question, chime in on the chat on YouTube, or you can hit Trey on Twitter, or his number, he's giving that out, right?
Haven't given it out, but if they've got it, they can call me. 0-2, Torbert quickly jumps ahead here. This is a very interesting question. I enjoy doing the research on this one and going back and seeing some of the names from yesteryear. 0-2, swing and a miss. So on three pitches, Paladar goes down in his 10th at bat of the season. And Torbert quickly bounces back after that walk to Banks Griffith. That'll bring up the shortstop, Andrew Estrella. 0-2 on the day, did reach on an error in his first at bat. First pitch to him, just off the outside corner. 1-0 the count on Estrella. Torbert sets at the belly button. Small kick and delivers the breaking ball in there for a strike. 1-1. Torbert, one of those seniors that will be honored tomorrow before the 2 o'clock game. One pitch. That one's popped up, and it will be out of play. Torbert jumps ahead 1-2. Torbert's fifth year here in the Owl program out of Hillgrove High School right here close by in Marietta, Georgia, and he has had a tremendous career for the Owls, bouncing back from some adversity as a sophomore. 1-2 pitch. Catches the inside corner for strike three as Estrella goes down but does not agree with the strike three call. That'll be two outs with a runner on first, and that'll bring up the center fielder, Cameron Hill. You can hear all about Luke Torbert's Owl career if you go and search on iTunes for the Riding the Bus podcast. He came on with me on the Riding the Bus podcast and talked about facing that adversity and how he was able to bounce back from it. That pitch to Hill's hit high and deep into right field. Back goes Kalina. Hill thinks he got it, and he did, as that one will land just beyond the right field wall, and that'll make the score 20-4 on the two-run home run by Cameron Hill, his third of the year. Give him RBIs number 25 and 26. So the ball is flying out of the yard today, which it usually does here in Kennesaw as it warms up. Those 330s down the line do not play quite that deep. And I've got a little secret for you, Nolan. It's not 330 down the right field line. We remeasured it when this new wall went up. First pitch to Traficante's fouled off his body at the plate. 0-1.
So there's false advertising in right
there
field.
There is false advertising down that right field line. It is not 330.
What is it?
I think it's like 317.
Wow, that is a big difference.
I think it's like 317 if that I remember correctly.
That is a huge difference.
0-1 the count. That pitch is right through there for a strike. 0-2 as Torbert quickly jumps back in the zone after the two-run home run.
What about left field?
Left field plays pretty true. I think it's a little bit short, maybe like a 328, but it's pretty close to that 330. I don't think it's 330 on the nose. 0-2. Strike three. Torbert's third strikeout of the inning. But not before the Hatters hit a two-run home run off the bat of Cameron Hill. Cut into that Owl lead a little bit. It is now 20-4 as we head to the bottom of the sixth here on the KSU Owl Network. We are back here on the KSU Owl Network, headed bottom of the sixth. New arm on the mound for the Hatters is going to be the freshman left-hander Cooper Smith, making his eighth appearance of the year. He's thrown nine innings to this point, giving up nine hits, five earned runs, eight walks, seven strikeouts. Opponents are hitting 281 against him. He will face 3, 4, and 5 in the Owls' order. Corbin, Cash, and Young. Corbin got to hit his first at bat. He's been retired the last three times. First pitch to him is a strike right through there from Smith. Grounded out to third, reached on an E6 and scored. Reached on a fielder's choice and scored. Three runs scored for him on the day. 0-1, downstairs, 1-1. New catcher behind the dish is Craig Pallader. One and one the count on Corbin, taking his second at bat of the day from the right side. That one's hit high and deep into left center field. Back goes Hill, still going. He leaps, and that ball is caught. What a nice play there by Cameron Hill. Stetson SID talked about how good he was defensively. He showed it with the bat last half inning, the two-run home run to right field. And then he shows off the amazing range right there, hauling that one in. Did not look like it was going to be a home run, but definitely ticketed for extra bases. Donovan Cash, 4-for-4 on the day, triple short of the cycle. First pitch to him, outside and low for a ball, 1-0.
And if this score wasn't 20-4, I would put an asterisk about that play from Hill in center field. Just an incredible job there.
1-0 pitch is high and outside. 2-0 on Donovan Cash. 4-for-4 on the day. Home run, two doubles, four RBIs. Throw in a single for good measure. 2-0 popped up. This one is sky high. It appears it'll stay in play. Cooper Smith, the pitcher, calls for it and makes the catch for out number two. So for the first time today, Donovan Cash is retired. On the pop-up to the pitcher, which you don't see happen a whole lot, but I've always contended that they're a whole lot better person to catch it than the catcher most of the time. That'll bring up Cash Young, who's 2-for-2 with a couple walks. He'll take strike one on the outside corner.
And really, if you go all the way back to the first inning, or second inning, with DiPonzio, who left after he was injured.
That ball's hit through the right side. A nice piece of hitting there by Cash Young. And a two-out single for the Owls here in the bottom of the sixth. They're on top 20-4, and that'll bring up Spencer Hansen.
But if DiPonzio is able to make that grab, that's two home runs that Stetson would have robbed today. One's more than enough, but two speaks to the defensive efforts of this outfield.
Spencer Hansen had one of the home runs on the day for the Owls, a grand slam. First pitch to him is in the dirt for a ball, 1-0. Grand slam, that came back in the fourth inning. He's also singled a couple of times and hit into a double play that ended the first inning. 1-0 pitch on the outside corner, 1-1. They're going to play behind Cash Young at first base, and rightfully so. He's not going to be going anywhere with the 16-run lead. 1-1 pitch to Hansen. That one catches the corner as well, as the strike zone has widened a little bit by home plate umpire Lee Ishman, and I do not blame him. One and two the count. Two outs here, bottom of the sixth. Breaking ball lands away for a ball, 2-2. Remind you of that trivia question. Which opponent has had the most hits against the other team? Which Owl has the most hits against the Hatters? Which Hatter has the most hits against the Owls? 2-2 downstairs and away for a ball. Fills up the count at 3-2. And that is all time. These two teams have met 48 times, with KSU leading 26 games to 22. 3-2 pitch, fouled off. That one skips by third base coach Derek Tucker and heads down the left field line. The series between these two teams dating all the way back to 2006. 3-2 pitch. That one's downstairs for a ball, and the Owls will have two on once again for Nick Kalina. Last time he came up in this position, he hit a three-run home run over the right field wall. It was Kalina's third home run of the year. RBI is 17, 18, and 19. Looking to add to that total here. First pitch to him. Misses low for a ball, 1-0. Pitch in there for a strike, 1-1. If you think you know the answer to that question, join in on the chat. You can put your answer in the chat. We'll give you a shout-out if you get it right, or you can reach out to me on Twitter, STF3333. Would love to hear from you. 1-1 pitch. Downstairs, 2-1. We talked a little bit last half inning about Luke Torbert being a fifth-year senior. He'll be honored tomorrow before the game. We talked about, if you want to hear his story and how he bounced back from adversity, which is a great story, check out his episode of the Riding the Bus podcast. 2-1 upstairs. 3-1, waiting on deck to pinch hit is Nathan Gravett. It looks like he will catch the rest of this ball game for Nick Hassan. Mason Jones came out of the game the other night against Western Carolina with a tweak of his knee. 3-1 pitch, low, and that will load the bases for the Owls.
Nothing like a little two-out rally up by 16 here in the sixth inning, right, Trey?
Absolutely not. And if Nate Gravett hits a grand slam, I believe I said this during the rout that the rambling wreck of Georgia Tech had here back in March. I said if he got a base hit, the dugout would come unglued, which they did at the time. If he hits a grand slam here, you hadn't seen anything yet. Nate Gravett getting his first career hit against the Yellow Jackets back in March here. First pitch to him is grounded out to short. Estrella's got it. He'll go the short way. That one's thrown away. One run will come in. That's Hatcher, or that's Cash Young. Here comes Hansen. Here comes Kalina as well, as the Owls will clear the bases on the E6. Another ball by the middle infielders that they just could not handle. And the Owls extend their lead to 23-4.
Tough day for Estrella. Incredibly difficult day for Stetson. 23-4.
If you are the Hatters, you're hoping that they get it all out today, meaning all the runs for the Owls. That'll bring up Joseph Gossett for his first at bat. That pitch is downstairs for a ball, 1-0. We've talked about Joey Gossett a little bit this year. One of those glue guys for this program, a lot like Nathan Gravett, does what they're asked to do, comes to work every single day. 1-0 pitch, hit foul and out of play down the right field line. Has not gotten a whole lot of opportunity, but you could not tell by his demeanor how they carry themselves at the ballpark and their effort each and every day, because they bring it as good as anyone. 1-1 the count, two outs here, bottom of the sixth. Owls on top, 23-4. And that one's fouled back. That'll make the count 1-2. Josh Hatcher waits on deck for what would be his sixth at bat of the day here in the sixth inning. Gossett steps back in, waves the bat a few times in front of the catcher, and here's the pitch outside, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. The pitch to Gossett, swing and a miss, and that will be out number three, but not before the Owls score three more times. We head to the seventh. Owls on top, 23-4. You're listening to KSU Baseball here on the KSU Owl Network. And we are back here on the KSU Owl Network. Some changes for the Owls. On the mound, making his first career pitching appearance, is going to be the freshman, number 33, Tyler Franks. In at third base is another one of those seniors that will be honored tomorrow, Gavin Patel. And we are going to answer that trivia question. Shout out to the Stetson Hatter Vision. And if that, those are my guys that do the games on the old school Hatter Vision, not sure who that is. If that is you, I have enjoyed listening to you over the years. I appreciate all of your broadcast. As a former coach, they were very helpful to us. And you got the right answer on the Stetson side. Jacob Coos, 17 career hits against the Owls, including a huge go-ahead hit here in a game eventually won by the Owls back in 2019. Jeremy Cruz was second on the list for the Hatters, and Vance Vizcaino with 14 was third. Topping the list for the Owls, two former middle infielders, Grant Williams and Dave Chabot, with 24 hits apiece. Brennan Morgan third on the list with 19. First pitch from Franks downstairs for a ball, 1-0. And Tyler Simon now has 18 hits against the Hatters. He's looking to climb up those rankings. But Dave Chabot, Grant Williams leading the way for the Owls. 1-0 pitches inside for a ball, or for a strike, 1-1. As Franks evens up the count. His first career appearance on the mound, had a couple of at-bats early in the year. 1-1 is popped out into left center field. On comes the left fielder, and sliding to make a wonderful catch is Joseph Gossett. So a nice play there in left field by Joey Gossett. He is a guy that we've talked about, has worked so hard on his defense, and it pays off right there. Trey Harmon will get the pinch hit at bat here. Former University of Kentucky Wildcat. First pitch to him's high. 1-0. Tyler Franks was a highly heralded recruit coming in this class. And pitching was one reason why. He can reach the low 90s. Obviously, you see the frame there. That one's in there for a strike. 1-1. But it looked like for a lot of the year that Tyler Franks might be the guy playing first base for the Owls, at least through the fall workouts. 1-1 pitch, swing and a miss. 1-2, he jumps ahead of Harmon. And he came back in the spring, had a rough start to the spring preseason inter-squads. Donovan Cash sort of took off, and it's amazing how their roles have reversed. 1-2 pitch, breaking ball, catches the corner for Steve Reich, number three, to Harmon. Give Franks his first career strikeout in an Owl uniform.
I love it. And looking at his report from high school, you said it, the fastball in the low 90s, curveball and a slider, and that was a great breaking ball right there. When you're up by 19, you know that strike zone is going to get expanded. You're ahead in the count. Yeah, why not try that backdoor bender?
First pitch here to Correa downstairs at 88 miles an hour from Franks. So it'll be very interesting to see how where Franks goes after this freshman year. Obviously, it seems as if Donovan Cash is over at that first base spot to stay in an Owl uniform. He has done such a tremendous job this year. 1-0 pitch, strike on the outside corner, evens the count at 1-1. And for Franks, they love the left-handed bat. Maybe his future progresses into a DH, possibly the outfield. He's played that a little bit as well. But if they could get some big-time stuff out of him on the mound, that would be a huge boost to this Owls club moving forward. 2-1 the count, two outs here, top of the seventh. Owls on top, 23-4. That one outside and low at 87 miles an hour. The count will move to 3-1. So once again, congratulations to Hatter Vision, who knew the answer was Jacob Coos. A very tough out for the Hatters. 3-1 pitch, grounded up the middle, ranging over to field is Cash Young. Over to first for out number three. Cash Young had taken over for Tyler Simon at short, and he gets the assist to end the top of the seventh inning. We head to the home half. Seventh inning stretch time here from Stillwell Stadium. Owls on top, 23-4. You're listening to Owls Baseball on the KSU Owl Network.
pitching for the Hatters is number 19, Jonathan Velasquez.
We're back here on the KSU Owl Network. Another new arm on the mound for the Hatters. And this is going to be Jonathan Velasquez, 6'3", 220-pound redshirt sophomore from Melbourne, Florida. He's making his eighth appearance on the year. No record, 7.36 ERA, 7 1/3 innings pitched, 6 hits, 6 runs all earned, 5 walks, 7 strikeouts on the year. Opponents hitting 207 against him. One more quick note about that trivia question. Dave Chabot, who sat atop the Owls list with Grant Williams, had a hit in every game he played against the Hatters. 15 games except for one. Sent him a text earlier today and told, and as I was doing the research for that question, have yet to hear back from him, but we talked about how he was an Hatter killer. First pitch to Hatcher is a strike from Velasquez. He jumps ahead 0-1.
And I found out that was Ricky the Reds fan behind Hatter Vision with the correct answer. Nice work, Ricky.
0-2 the count on Hatcher. Hatcher 2-for-5 on the day with an RBI. A couple runs scored. 0-2. That one's popped up into left center. Who wants it? Keel over. Settling underneath it, he will make the grab for out number one to lead off the bottom of the seventh. That'll bring up Gavin Patel, his first at-bat of the day. Came on for Tyler Simon defensively an inning ago as Cash Young slid over to shortstop. First pitch to him, breaking ball in there for a strike, 0-1. Patel, the Gordon State transfer. He'll be honored tomorrow on Senior Day. 0-1, down low. 1-1. Gavin Patel actually started opening day for the Owls at first base this year. 1-1 pitch. Buzzes the tower. 2-1. Pitch, breaking ball, hit into center field. In comes Hill. He ranges over, makes the catch as he cuts in front of Traficante for out number two.
And looking back on that opening day, Trey, that was a fun one. First game for the Ryan Coe era. The Braves World Series trophy made its first appearance at a college campus. We got our pictures made with the trophy. There's a long line up that first baseline. Owls won, beat Morehead State. In front of over 700 fans.
First pitch to Corbin. Outside for a strike. Catches the corner. 0-1. And my apologies to John. He got another correct answer. He knew the Owls half of the question. 1-1 the count. He said, and his response was, always Grant Williams, always. Which is always a good answer to go with. Grant Williams played and started all 4 years. 0-1's fouled off down the left field line and out of play. And he is one of the Owls that – one of 10 Owls now, after Tyler Simon did it earlier this year, that has over 200 hits in his Owl career. Currently in AAA with the Red Sox. 0-2. Breaking ball. That one will be in there for strike three, and that will end the bottom half of the seventh inning. Owls held scoreless for the first time since the fourth, but they remain on top. 23-4 as we head to the eighth here on the KSU Owl Network. And we are back here on the KSU Owl Network. That's it for me. I'm going to turn it back over to Nolan, and he'll carry you the rest of the way here as the Owls lead 23-4.
Thank you very much, Trey. You brought the Owls some runs. I wonder what Western Carolina's offense is up to today.
Without me in the yard, they're probably scoreless right now against Wofford. We'll check those scores at the bottom half of the inning.
Tyler Franks on for his second inning of work, made his first career appearance on the bump in the last inning. 1-2-3 against the Hatters, and he starts out low. 1-0 here against Kyle Ball. Sits 1-for-3 today with an RBI. Lefty on righty. The pitch is grounded directly to short and misplayed at short by Cash Young. As Trey noted, he moved over to short in the previous half inning when Gavin Patel entered, took third. So Young doesn't always see that look exactly from short and a ground ball hit to him. It's an error and a leadoff base runner for Stetson here in the eighth.
Shortstop is where he played at Georgia College last year, but I think only the second time he's seen any action there this year.
Griffith up at the dish, and he takes a strike at the knees from Franks, also a righty batter, 0-1. Came on as a pinch hitter, drew a walk, and scored a run. He's 4-for-36 on the year with a couple RBI, and the lefty delivers, swinging a fly ball to center field, and that pops in for a base hit and almost misplayed in center by Hatcher. So the first two men are aboard for Stetson. Well, we spoke about the scores, and we'll check that Western Carolina score. The Liberty-Florida Gulf Coast game was delayed an hour due to severe thunderstorms in Fort Myers, which I hope isn't a foreshadowing of what's to come in a couple of weeks. But they're about to get underway. And a pitch from Franks runs low beneath the zone. 1-0.
It is 100% a foreshadowing for what's going to happen at the conference tournament.
I was just trying not to speak it into existence.
Oh, it's going to happen.
Paladar up here, lefty on righty, and the delivery just misses away 2-0.
There's one thing that you can guarantee is going to happen at the conference tournament. There's going to be rain, and there's going to be delays in the game.
2-0. Swinging a foul to the backstop, 2-1. Top of the sixth inning on the West Division side, Eastern Kentucky leads Lipscomb 3-2. Bottom two from Jacksonville. The Dolphins hosting the North Florida Ospreys. They're scoreless. Now, there was weather earlier. 2-1 pitch comes in high. 3-1. In the Jacksonville area, we know that from affecting the A-Sun Outdoor Track and Field Championships and the softball tournament, both hosted by UNF this weekend. 3-1. And low for ball four. The bases are full of Hatters. KSU up 23-4 here in the eighth inning. No outs. Estrella up out of the nine hole. Other scores around the A-Sun in the West Division. Top six, North Alabama leads Bellarmine 5-1. And top two from Jacksonville. Central Arkansas over Jack State 1-0. Franks delivers. It's fought off the hands, blooped towards the Stetson dugout, and lands just in front of the railing, 0-1.
And just for the record, Western Carolina has scored one run through three times at the plate. Against Wofford, at Wofford, they're down 3-1.
So did you get a job offer the next day? Did you get a phone call at least?
No phone calls.
0-1. Fouled back to the net, 0-2.
I tried to offer my services out to a state Final Four series between North Hall and Pike County for Monday. Still waiting to hear back on that one.
Kick, southpaws 0-2, swinging a foul as Estrella remains alive and takes it to the Owls dugout. I've been to both those schools. I actually called a playoff series in Pike County a long time ago, back in high school. Middle Georgia, what's the town there, do we know?
Zebulon.
Mm. And the pitch is swung on, delivered into left field. Gossett coming on for the grab, and runner holds over at third. Gossett with a strong throw into the infield.
That throw is going to be a one-hop right on the money. So good decision there, holding the runner at third base. Yeah, I've got one of my best friends, Wes Crow, assistant coach, actually the 2021 assistant coach of the year in the state of Georgia. Coaches at North Hall, one of my former players that I tried to recruit. He kept turning me down. Blake Parrott's the assistant at Pike County.
First pitch here to Hill is popped out of play to the left field side, 0-1.
Pike County, the home of future Kennesaw State Owl, Braden Osbolt, who's a senior right-handed pitcher there this year. He'll go in that series against the Trojans of North Hall. Also home to former Kennesaw State commit and current AA Angel, Coleman Crow, who won a state championship back in 2019 for the Pirates.
0-1 fouled off again, 0-2. Do have an update that just came through from the Stetson Sports Information Director, Ricky. Nick DiPonzio is okay, news from the trainers, and that is great to hear. DiPonzio gave a phenomenal effort on what ended up being a Tyler Simon grand slam in the second inning. The left fielder went up against the covered window and left. The pitch, a breaking ball, spoiled out of play again third base side. And he did not get up for quite a while. The training staff, both training staffs, went out to attend to him. Steve Trimper, the Hatters head coach, other outfielders, Estrella, the shortstop. He was helped up with support of the trainers, evaluated, left the ballgame immediately after that. But we're very happy to hear he's okay. Pitch in the dirt, rolls off the protection, rolls to the Hatter on deck circle, but runners hold.
Pretty good job there by catcher Nate Gravett of knocking and getting a piece of that ball right there. Kicked away from him a little bit, but able to get there before a run could score.
Base is still loaded here with one out. 2-2 from Tyler Franks. Swing and a fly ball to left field. This sends Gossett back, has a beat on it, reaches out for the grab. Runner tacks from third. Ball comes in to score, and Stetson makes it 23-5.
Good piece of two-strike hitting there by Cameron Hill. Staying late, lining the ball to left field, allowing the run to score.
It's a third RBI for Hill today. So two on, two outs. 23-5, Kennesaw State on top. And the offering is ripped directly to second base and snared there by Corbin. A nice job. Traficante lines out, and that'll do it for the Hatters in the eighth inning. Stetson adds 1-2 its total. We go bottom eight, 23-5, Kennesaw State on the KSU OWL Network. Game one of three between the Kennesaw State Owls and the Stetson Hatters. Sees a 23-5 lead for KSU. Three in the first, six in the second, four in the fourth, seven in the fifth, three in the sixth inning. A couple of grand slams for the Owls. Part of a 20-hit effort today. KSU batting here. It's Velasquez deals, and Donovan Cash takes down and away 1-0. Cash has had a monster day today.
A triple away from the cycle. He's 4-for-5 with four ribbies, and the pitch is a slider that catches the outer half, 1-1. 46 RBI in the season, 18 doubles, 5 home runs, including one tonight. Takes the 1-1 and slams it deep into left field, and the left fielder runs back over there and makes the grab. Connor Keel jumps up to snare it. How'd he misplay that? Depending on where that ball had bounced, Cash may have had a shot at the cycle.
He would have had a chance there, possibly. But nice play by Connor Keel.
Keel kind of danced around and then climbed the ladder to snare it. Cash Young looks at a breaking ball in the outer half of the zone, 0-1. Owls 23, Hatters 5 here in the eighth. Velasquez deals. Swinging a chopper foul, third base side. 2 o'clock is the first pitch time tomorrow in Game 2 for Kennesaw State and Stetson. It'll be Senior Day. Senior class honored 20 minutes before. Trey Fowler to my right, and Michael Goss will have the call. 0-2 breezes him as he leans back out of the way, up and in, 1-2. Chris Gonzalez takes the hill for Stetson. The lefty's 1-4 with a 4.98 ERA. John Bez to check for the Owls. Another lefty, 3-1 with a 3.81 ERA. Swinging a grounder, pulled foul up the line at third. Remains 1-2. And the teams will close it out Sunday at 1 in Game 3. 1-2 pitch. A fastball lined back up the middle and past the shift. At the middle infield, of Griffith playing close to behind the bag. And Cash Young is able to spot it just to the left of the shifting second baseman. And it's a one-out single.
Fourth hit of the day for Young. Four perfect, 4-for-4 on base 6 times today is Cash Young. And he went to the left of the shift and to the right of the shift in his last 2 at-bats. Good to see from him.
The pitch. And Spencer Hansen lines it foul opposite way, grounding it up the first baseline. 3-for-4 today, capped off by the grand slam. For his third home run of the season. And drilled it over the left field wall. Righty on righty, 0-1. Breaking ball through the wicket. The catcher, Paladar, but comes right back to him as Young holds on at first. So, Trey, I wanted to ask you this question earlier, and I want to make sure this is crystal clear. I do not mean this with any sort of smart remark, but I want to put yourself in your coach's hat again. 1-1 to Hansen. Swinging a hot grounder fair up the third baseline. Extra bases again potentially here for Hansen. Young round second base. The throw from Keel from left is a good one, and the swipe, and he's out. I made sure to say potential, knowing what Keel could do over in left field, and he gives a fantastic throw to the second baseman, Griffith. Hansen with a single, but out 7-4.
There's that arm that Ricky Hazel told us about that Connor Keel possesses. He talked about both him and Pregent being defensive weapons for this Hatter bunch.
Runner at third, 2 outs for Colino. Swings the first pitch and spoils it out of play behind us. 23-5 KSU. Okay, so my question is, and again, I don't mean this in a smart remark, but when the game got out of hand early, if you're Stetson in that situation, as the pitch runs down and in, what's the message then? What do you say to your team to keep them engaged in the ball game when it's difficult to do so?
Well, you look for a way to control what you can, which is what is in front of you, not what is behind you. You look for anything to build momentum for the next day. The Owls have done a good job stymieing any possible momentum by continuing to score in just about every inning, but that's what the goal is.
Pitch missed away. Now a 2-1 offering, and that one's high, 3-0.
And at the end of the day, the old Vin Diesel rule applies. It doesn't matter if you win by an inch or a mile or if you lose by an inch or a mile. They all count the same, and tomorrow is a new day.
3-1 to Kalina is drilled deep out to center field, but it stays in the ballpark as Hill gets there right at the edge of the warning track. And so Kennesaw State strands a runner over at third base. Couple hits in the inning. That's it for the Owls. To the ninth we go. KSU 23, Stetson 5 on the KSU Owl Network.
sure to be here early to help celebrate our eight senior owls. For more information on the purchase of tickets, call the box office at 470-578-4965 or visit www.ksuowls.com/tickets.
To the ninth we go. Kennesaw State running away in game one of three between the Owls and the Hatters. Their final home series of 2022, 23-5 the score. Nolan Alexander here with Trey Fowler and a new pitcher on the bump for the Owls, a 6'2", 185-pound freshman out of Roswell in the Weber School, Slade Notterman, who last pitched against Georgia Southern on the road on April 27th. Notterman in to spell Tyler Franks after his KSU debut in the bump, and Notterman rockets home with fastball. 0-1 the count here to Keel. Had a great grab in the outfield and threw out Spencer Hansen trying to leg it out for a double. 0-1 pitch is a slider that hangs high, a ball and a strike.
So down in Fort Myers, that bad Florida Gulf Coast defense rears its ugly head in the first inning against Liberty.
Swing and a miss on a fastball, 1-2.
As they make two errors, and Liberty scores three times to take an early 3-0 lead in the ballgame.
Notterman works off the first base side of the rubber, is 1-2 pitch. Fastball down and away, 2-2. A 7.50 ERA, a whip of 1.50 in six innings this year with five earned, four walks, six strikeouts.
That's a bad defense. We didn't see much from the Eagles a weekend ago.
2-2 fastball aligns the outside corner. Keel down looking, one away. So, fast forwarding ahead to tomorrow, Trey, going off the point you're talking about, Stetson trying to find some momentum. What's the mindset for each of these squads refreshing to a 2 p.m. start Saturday? And the pitch is looped over to short, a bobbling grab by Cash Young. That one fought off the hands by Harmon, curled back to Young. A snow cone popped out, brought it back in the paper cup, two away.
If you're the Owls, both teams, it's the same thing. You have to reset. Tomorrow is a new day. What you did today does not matter, good or bad. You have to focus on what is in front of you. Focus on the present. A lot of big things still lay in front of both of these teams. They're both still fighting. The Owls fighting for position in the conference tournament. A-Sun East crown on the line.
0-1 runs up inside some high cheese. Gets Juan Cray, the DH, 1-1.
And the Hatters are looking to get in the tournament where anything can happen. They know it just as well as anybody. We mentioned it. The 2016 team came in as the last seed, steamrolled through the tournament to a regional.
Notterman trying to finish off Correa here, the DH, with a 2-1 count.
It will be very interesting to see how both teams come out. Obviously, the Owls will be jacked up. It'll be senior day, coming off a big win. Stetson limping to the finish a little bit.
2-1 is sent out of play to right field. Hatters down to their last strike at 2-2.
But that's the mark of a good coaching staff and a good team led by quality individuals at the top, like a Kyle Ball, like a Christian Pregent. They're not going to let this team quit. They're not going to let this team lay down. They'll be ready to play tomorrow, and I expect a much better performance.
2-2. Fastballs in the basement. 3 balls, 2 strikes. Stetson today, 4-for-30 at the dish, 3-for-16 with runners on, 1-for-9 in scoring position. The Owls 22-of-46, 15-of-25 when they're on. Payoff pitch popped up out of play behind the box. And 9-of-17, that's 529, with runners in scoring position.
The strikeout of Keel by Natterman was the 11th of the day for the Owls.
Payoff from Natterman. Popped up again now to play to right field. 23 runs off 22 hits, 2 errors, and 5 stranded for the Owls. Three-two, swing and a blooper to center field and fielded by Hatcher with two hands to close the ball game. The Parliament pounds Stetson here tonight, 23-5 over the Hatters. KSU went up 3-1 after the first inning, then 9-1 after the second. That's all the Owls needed, highlighted by grand slams from Tyler Simon and Spencer Hansen. And the Owls with a statement win here, coming off a series loss prior to this against FGCU, won in the midweek against Western Carolina, and opened up with an exclamation point here tonight, Trey. A good win for KSU.
Very good win when they are trying to set a resume to be overlooked by the committee in terms of an at-large bid. They have to win games like this at home against lower RPI teams. A loss in this situation would be very detrimental to any at-large hopes. They've got to keep putting wins together, continue building that resume, hopefully giving themselves a shot next weekend to take the A-Sun East crown from Liberty up in Lynchburg.
Well, a fun one here for the Owls, who win big over Stetson, 23-5 for our entire production crew. My partner, Trey Fowler, I'm Nolan Alexander, saying good night from the Shake, where the Parliament parties 23-5 over Stetson. Senior day tomorrow. Get to the ballpark early. Honor this senior class. Done a lot for Kennesaw State, no matter their longevity here at KSU. 20 minutes prior to first pitch, 2 p.m. start. Trey and Michael Gospel at the call. I'm Nolan Alexander. Good night, and God bless here from the Shake.